Most intense rivalries in all of college football. These clubs met for the first time back in 1897, and after more than a century of a rivalry that is tough to beat, they are ready to brawl again.
Crazy.
It's big time. It's more than just a game.
You're either a Grizzly or you're a Bobcat. There is no, well, it doesn't make any difference.
It's so much pride within the state, and it just elevates and elevates into just an explosion on that first kickoff.
I mean, I get a lot of help that week before the game. With emails, letters, cards from people, play calling suggestions, things that don't happen during the regular season.
It's honestly like a war. Trash talking, guys just do not like each other.
We call it Cat Grizz, they call it Grizz Cat. You know, I mean, you have to have your priorities there.
It is probably, you know, as good a rivalry as there is.
There's a trophy that goes back and forth called the Divide Trophy. They're on one side of the Continental Divide and we're on the other side of the Continental Divide. It's kind of like the Hatfields and the McCoys. I mean, some people are on one side of the fence or the other and there's no turning their colors.
One word, undescribable.
Great to have alongside Sed Bonner, and Sed, as is always the case, so much on the line when these two teams get together.
It really is an emotional game it's going to be. These guys have been preparing for this all year. Families are involved. This lineage goes way back, playing for the Divide Trophy. This is going to be an awesome game, and for the winner, a big Christmas present.
Final week of play in the Big Sky Conference. To take a look, four teams sharing the top spot. Montana State will need a little bit of help to get the automatic bid into the FCS playoffs. They're going, but with a win today and that number two national ranking, they are going to be a lock to get some home playoff action. Let's talk about the quarterbacks in this game. Starting first of all, Sed, with the winningest quarterback in Montana State history in Denarius McGee.
Yeah, he's done an outstanding job since stepping on the campus, really took hold of, embraced this offense, done a nice job. His unique skill sets allows him to run the ball, throw the ball with accuracy, coming off a game where he was 12 of 17 for four touchdown passes, 232 yards, rounding into real shape right now, heading towards the playoffs.
Guy who knows all about pressure-packed situations and certainly knows all about the brawl of the wild, Denarius McGee. But on the flip side, Shea Smith-Wickham is getting his first start in this rivalry at quarterback for Montana.
And it's a tough place to get your first start or your third start of your career in this game. But if anybody can handle, he can. He's been very poised since taking over 2.5 games ago. 742 yards passing, 7 TDs, has an understanding for this offense, has gotten off to a good start in his career.
This game features two of the outstanding running backs in the Big Sky Conference, Cody Kirk of Montana State, Peter Wynn of Montana. One's finesse, one's power, but the bottom line is they both know how to get the job done.
They really do. They run similar type of offenses, and they both do a great job out of that zone read, reading things. Cody Kirk, big physical back, 7 TDs in his last three games, over 391 yards, has carried this team and is getting healthy at the right time of the year.
Had a huge game last week against Portland State. Peter Wynn, just Mr. Versatility, stepped up big time earlier this year when Dan Moore went down.
He really did, and has carried the tote for this team. Two out of the last three games, over 100 yards, just one touchdown. But where the guy makes his big difference is on the special team. In the return game, over 1,182 all-purpose yards, terrific player.
Defensively, we got two of the best in the nation when it comes to getting to the quarterback. Zach Wagenman of Montana, Caleb Schreibeis of Montana State. And for more on that dynamic duel, we go to our on-field analyst, Jason Stiles.
Yeah, guys, you talk to anybody during the week, and they say this game is going to be won in the trenches. Both of these defenses play so well, and they do it with their front seven. When you talk about who gets it done, it's Caleb Schreibeis from Montana State. It's Zach Wagenman for Montana. Both can get it done, but Caleb Schreibeis is unbelievable. Just recently this week, named to a list for the top players in FCS. 11 sacks on the year, 7 forced fumbles, a great motor. Has absolutely wrecked offenses this year. Oh, by the way, he has forced one fumble in the last three games, a former walk-on for the Montana State Bobcats. On the other side, Zach Wegman, they call him Wags here in Missoula, another guy that they will play in different spots on the defensive line. He'll start at tackle, he'll move outside, but wherever he is, he makes things happen. 11 sacks on the year, 12.5 tackles for loss, 2 forced fumbles. He really has got a great motor, just a sophomore on this defense that has caused everybody issues. Tom said these guys are going to be working to force turnovers. Both of these teams have shown that they will turn it over. It could be a big part of this football game to decide who wins.
Game Within the Game said, both of those guys would love to end the season not only with a win today, but as the SAC champion in the Big Sky Conference.
Absolutely, and it's going to come down to whichever offensive line could utilize their skill set to keep those guys out of the backfield, keep muffing up plays. It's going to be a big-time brawl.
Wind picking up a bit here in Missoula. We have more coverage coming your way. The Brawl of the Wild right here on Root Sports.
Right now, Ford has the freshest lineup in America. So, we're at the mall, celebrating.
F-150, best-in-class towing, payload, hauling, and all other capabilities.
It's four thumbs up.
EcoBoost engine, it's so important we actually write it. So 22 miles on the highway.
Statistically, it embarrasses the competition.
That's what I heard.
I don't know how you like to celebrate. I like to come here and listen to myself talk.
Yeah. Get a new Ford F-150 with up to $6,500 total cash back. That's $6,500. So don't miss the Ford year-end celebration on now at your local Ford store.
Economy for 160 years. BNSF, the engine that connects us.
I love it. Our fans are crazy. They start tailgating early in the morning, don't finish till late at night.
You know, they sell out basically every game. You know, their fans are right on top of you.
I love their crowd, and I mean, I love the heckling and everything they do, so I really feed into that.
A very hostile environment. Their fans can get very rowdy.
They just feed off touchdowns we score or sacks. It definitely, definitely gets going and rocking.
It is quite a place to play as the energy builds here at Washington Grizzly Stadium in Missoula. We need to catch up with the head coaches in this game. We're going to start, first of all, with a gentleman who last week became the winningest coach in Montana State history. A little bit earlier, Jen Mueller caught up with Rob Ash.
All right, thank you, Tom. And Coach, this is a game that fans love to see. It is a rivalry game, and you've got offense, the best offense against the best defense. What's the biggest key for your defense today?
Well, we've got to try to get that running game stopped or slowed down at least. Montana does an awesome job of running the football. The backs are quick. The line is huge. And they have good schemes. And they have a good mix of zone and power and pin and pull, different kinds of plays. So it's a big challenge, but that's what we have to try to do.
You have a very seasoned group of seniors, though, who know how to win in all different situations, including here. How much does that help today?
Well, I think when you win, it becomes a habit, and I think that's how our team feels right now. You know, in 2010, 2 years ago, we really weren't over the hump yet. We had had a good season, but we hadn't won this game on the road, and so getting that under our belt helps our confidence, I think, and then we've won a lot of close games and a lot of, late games, late drives in the fourth quarter, overtime games over the last 2 or 3 years, so our guys feel good. If it's a close game, that we'll fight in there and try to get something done.
All right, and you know that nerves are high, a little anxiety. Coach didn't sleep much last night. I didn't either. Hopefully, Jenny Kavanaugh on the Montana sideline got a little bit more sleep. Jenny?
Thanks, Jen. I think a sleepless night just comes with the territory of the Cat Grizz game. Coach Delaney, you've been on both sidelines, but this is your first time as a head coach in this rivalry game. Have the emotions been any different for you this week?
Well, they are different. You know, when you have your own little group of guys, your five, six, seven guys, it's kind of nice. I've said a couple times, I like that seat on the other side of the hall a lot too. But you know, you get over where you have the responsibilities of the entire group. Actually, the emotions are different, I think. Probably a little bit more broad picture than you are when you're zeroing in on what your guys have to do. So, but it's been exciting. It's just a tremendous honor and very humbling to be 70 years old and be coaching the Montana Grizzlies, in this 112th game. It's just been an awesome week.
an awesome week, an awesome 2 weeks. You've had the bye week to do a little extra preparation for Montana State. What in that time has your offense been able to do, especially with the addition of Dan Moore coming back on the field today to counter this number one ranked conference defense?
Well, you know, the bye week was great. We practiced Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Very crisp and very sharp. You know, we only went about an hour and 15 minutes each day. And basically, we didn't do any Montana State preparation those 3 days. We just kind of took care of ourselves, brushed up, cleaned up some things that, you know, that we'd struggled with off and on through the season, and just tried to get our, you know, our bodies healed and our minds. You know, you go 17 or 16 weeks from the opening of camp. I think the bye for us came at a very, very good time.
Coach, thanks so much for your time. Best of luck today. Tom, we'll get it back upstairs to you.
Jenny, thanks so much. So there you have it from the coaches. The table is set, and we are ready for the biggest and baddest rivalry in Big Sky football, Montana State, Montana. The opening kickoff is coming your way. It's the Brawl of the Wild, and it's next on Root Sports.
Every communications provider is different, but CenturyLink is committed to being a different kind of communications company.
Do what you want when you want to. We all have time with a different kind of connection.
We link people in Fortune 500 companies nationwide and around the world, and we will continue to free you to do more and focus on what matters.
Yeah, link up and go now. Link up and go now.
Welcome to Chevy's year-end event.
So the 5.3-liter V8 Silverado can tow up to 9,600 pounds?
315 horsepower.
What's that in reindeer power?
Chevy's giving more. This holiday season, get 0% APR financing for 60 months or get the 2012 Chevy Silverado All-Star Edition with a total value of $8,000. Plus, trade up for an additional $1,000 trade-in allowance.
Welcome to Chevy's year-end event.
So the 5.3-liter V8 Silverado can tow up to 9,600 pounds?
315 horsepower.
What's that in reindeer power?
Chevy's giving more. This holiday season, get 0% APR financing for 60 months or get the 2012 Chevy Silverado All-Star Edition with a total value of $8,000. Plus, trade up for an additional $1,000 trade-in allowance.
When the ring makes way for the cage, it can only mean one thing.
Mixed Martial Arts Fighting.
Only at the Emerald Queen Casino I-5 Tacoma. Saturday, December 1st. Get ready for two title fights. Heavyweight Mike Hayes takes on Wild Bill Whibler. And in the second co-main event, Julian Erosa faces off with Drew Brokenshire. Seven more action-packed bouts round out the evening with many local favorites. Tickets are available through Ticketmaster or the Emerald Queen Casino. The Emerald Queen Casino, the entertainment capital of the Northwest.
You can ask any player that's playing football, from, you know, little guy football to college football, you know, what's the deal this weekend? And they're going to either say the Cats are going to win or the Grizz are going to win.
It's honestly like a war. It's trash talking. Guys just do not like each other.
When you walk on that field and you know you got the Grizzlies, and I know it's probably the same for them, you know, you want to put your heart out on the line, try to bring home that W for the Cat fans.
It's kind of like the Hatfields and the McCoys. I mean, some people are on one side of the fence or the other, and there's no turning their colors.
Once the Grizz Bobcat week comes along, you're either a Grizzly or you're a Bobcat. It is probably, you know, as good a rivalry as there is.
Welcome back inside an electric Washington Grizzly Stadium in Missoula, the second-rated Montana State Bobcats taking the field, a record of 9-1, followed by the Montana Grizzlies, a record of 5-5, and hoping to avoid their first losing season since 1985. As you see some of the fans here, it looks like they're friends, but maybe not for the next 3 hours or so, as we are happy to have you with us on Root Sports for the 112th meeting of the Brawl of the Wilds. Sid, talk about what it means to play in a rivalry game.
100 years running, there's a lot of deep-rooted hatred between these two teams. And you could just see the players. There's tension on the field. Players warmed up across from each other. They're ready to go. But which one of these teams are going to be able to channel that and try to get that win this afternoon?
Well, it's a rivalry that began back in 1897 when Montana State was called the Aggies and Montana was called the Mountain Lions. Over the years, the names and faces may have changed, but the brawl has lived on, not only in the intensity on the field, but also in the hearts and minds of Montanans everywhere. Today, it's a rivalry renewed for the 112th time, 1897. And they are ready to get after it again today. Montana State will receive the opening kickoff. Everett Gilbert, Sean Johnson back deep to receive for the Bobcats, who last week a very impressive blowout victory at home against Portland State. Chris Leiter, number 87, redshirt freshman, will be kicking off for the Montana Grizzlies. There's Sean Johnson, who last week had a punt return for a kickoff. Averages 22 yards per return. Everett Gilbert averages 26.2 yards per kickoff return. And we are underway in Missoula. Sean Johnson from his seven. Brought down out near the 26-yard line. Number 9, Denarius McGee leads the Montana State offense, the winningest quarterback in Montana State history this season. 21 touchdowns, just 8 interceptions. All-time passing yardage over 8,000. And a junior out of Euless, Texas, said who knows how to lead this football team.
Knows how to make plays when there's trouble to be had. He's a great at Liberty.
McGee, a wide open target. Kruiz Siewing out near a first down at the 36-yard line. Bo Tully with the coverage for Montana. 10-yard gain and a first down. Our on-field analyst, Jason Stiles. And Jason, nice effective way for that Montana State offense to start things today.
Yeah, up-tempo. We see a lot of that from Montana, but Montana State a little bit of their own medicine here early on, trying to take the crowd out of it.
McGee wide open, John Ellis. And Ellis still on his feet and brought down 2 yards short, an 8-yard gain for John Ellis. 5'10", a 180 junior out of Mansfield, Texas.
It's just a simple show flash to the run. Anthony Goodwin's got to do a better job coming up and tackling in space because they're going to the bubble receiver where there's a gap or an opening. They're attacking that area with a receiver.
So two pass plays right out of the gate for the Bobcats. First running play goes to Cody Kirk. And looks like he'll be denied a first down by a yard. Cody Kirk, a 5'10", 208-pound junior out of Frenchtown, Montana, just about 15 miles west of Missoula. Third down and one. Montana State has been outstanding this season on third down conversions, connecting 53% of the time, number 2 in the conference. Kirk stacked up and will not get the first down, a loss of a yard. Brock Coyle, middle linebacker for Montana, the first Grizzly there, the 6'2 sophomore out of Bozeman.
They go with the off-tackle power. Poor tackle. Everything gets spilled into the backfield. You see Jordan trip in on the tackle along with Coyle. And just too much pressure up front. Those big nasties up front, talking about Takai and Benjamin, doing a great job at the point of attack.
Rory Perez on to punt, averaging nearly 41 yards per boot. Back deep to return, Peter Wynn, senior out of Bellevue, Washington, who has one punt return this season for a touchdown, covering 90 yards. Wynn will signal for the fair catch and make it at his own 10-yard line. Good punt that time for Montana State by Rory Perez. Starting quarterback for the Montana Grizzlies, Shea Smith-Wickham, 6'4", sophomore. Look at his numbers this season. Came into the starting lineup just a few weeks ago during a game at North Dakota and has not relinquished that spot. 8 touchdowns, 3 interceptions, and had a solid performance 2 weeks ago in Montana's last game at Weber State. Gerald Kemp in motion, the handoff to Wynn, whips some room, and Peter Wynn still on his feet and driving out to the 24-yard line. Moy Akiola, Caleb Schreibison on the stop for the Bobcats.
Catch Jody Owens in a blitz from the backside. He runs himself out of the play, gets caught up in the slack there by Schreibison. Look at the strength of this little guy. Not something you think of him when he's running the balls with power, but you see with effort and determination, he's able to get a nice gain.
14-yard pickup for Peter Wynn, who has a chance today to reach 2,000 rushing yards in his career. Here goes Wynn again, full of energy, busting it to the outside, and finally hauled down at the 45-yard line by Stephen Beckley. 21-yard gain for Peter Wynn to follow up his 14-yard carry.
Well, we talked about this big offensive line, Schmang Henderson doing a great job on the front side, but once again, you're making a good player in the hole, Joe Fuller, miss. Watch what he does to Joe Fuller right there in the hole, leaves him in his shoes, and gets a nice guy. I mean, this guy is electrifying. Doesn't have the greatest speed, but just has quick bursts and understands how to run the football.
And for the first time in 5 games, senior Dan Moore in the backfield. Play fake to Moore. Smithwick hand with the pitch. Joey Counts gets around the edge and counts down to the Montana State 42-yard line. A gain of 12. And Jason, what are you seeing in the trenches that's opening up these big holes right now for the Grizzlies?
Well, there's such a huge size advantage for Montana, especially on the right side of that offensive line. I mean, it's a combined over 650 pounds between guard and tackle, and they're really getting it done up front, and they're making people miss one-on-one.
So gains on the ground of 14, 22, and 12. First down, Grizzlies. Dan Moore stacked up in the middle. That's where you got those big tackles, or at least the big tackle for Montana State, and Zach Minter plugging things up. Let's take a look at our By the Numbers, brought to you by Northern Quest Casino, and Jason referring to the size up front. The big advantage, offensive line for Montana versus the defensive line for Montana State. Smithwick hand overshoots his intended receiver, Mitch Saylor.
You know, one of the things we talked about early on is building some confidence for Smithwick hand early on in this game, get him some good ball control passes so that he can get in a rhythm. And you can tell a little excitement from the freshman right there, airmailing a little hitch route.
37-pound on average advantage, offensive line Montana, defensive line Montana State. The other way around, things are pretty even. Third down at 9. And with Ann, with time, over the middle, the target, it's caught, and a terrific block, and that frees up Dan Hardy. Check it, Greg Hardy, to get down to the 5-yard line. Stephen Beckley with a tackle.
I'm not sure if he's throwing that to Hardy or to the crosser. You're gonna see a receiver coming that direction right there, and right there it ends up being a terrific block downfield by Kipps, and could have been called an offensive pass interference there, but a great job of getting the ball into a big tight end's hands.
35-yard gain to one of the 12 seniors on this Montana roster, Greg Hardy, on first and goal. Smithwick hand back in the end zone, overshoots his intended receiver, Bryce Carver. He was open.
I would say this is absolutely an emotional throw right here. You're gonna see double drags, and look at this man right here. All you gotta do is lob it right back in that area, and the excitement of getting on the board, having this crowd erupt, got a little bit too much right there for him.
And Deontay Flowers on the play. Second down and goal from the six. Hand off to Wynn, and nothing doing that time. He was laid out by Schreibeis at the five. Jody Owens also in on the play for Montana State.
It looks like this defense is starting to settle down. They're a little bit on their heels on those initial plays, but they've started to settle down and caught a break on that overthrow. We'll see how Smith McCann responds on third down here.
McCann, corner of the end zone. Incomplete. Ball batted away at the last moment by Stephen Beffley. Free safety. Very good coverage by the junior out of Chino, California. Intended receiver was Sam Gratton.
Yeah, guys, and I don't know if you'd see it from up there, but it sure looked like Smith McCann a little late with the football.
Absolutely.
Trying to get it out to Gratton. In games like you've got to throw the football on time, but it also shows, I think, a little bit of a fear on hand's part to not want to make a mistake. You know, wide open touchdown two times in that series, and both times couldn't deliver the football.
Extremely late, and that's a great point there, Jay. You know, he comes out of his break, and the ball's not in the air yet. And on this level, you got to make those plays, or guys are going to recover.
Chris Leiter, 23-yard field goal attempt is no good, so the Montana State defense holds after Montana had a first and goal from the 6-yard line as we remain scoreless in the brawl of the wild.
Meet Figgle, the free app that rewards you simply for watching DirecTV. Just check in to your favorite shows and start earning points towards a mocha latte, a designer tee, or a trip across the Mediterranean Sea. Hey, they're your points. You choose how to spend them. Download the free Figgle app today and enter promo code DirecTV to unleash exclusive offers and 4,000 bonus points. DirecTV and Figgle. You love TV. Isn't it time TV loved you back?
Political intrigue.
I am not the enemy here. You do not want to make me one.
An ally betrayed.
I will never forgive you for this.
A plot for revenge.
After everything you did to him, and now you plot deadly revenge?
Only one show can bring you this kind of drama. Call me Fitz.
Fitz o'clock, I'm a councilman now.
Why are we in a naked lady bar?
Die! Die! Why won't you die?
An all-new Call Me Fitz, Tuesday, November 27th, on the Audience Network.
Hey, DirecTV customers, are you ready for another season of nonstop NFL action on DirecTV's Red Zone channel? Each Sunday, we'll take you around the league for live look-ins on every game.
Oh, what a catch!
This is unbelievable.
He's got it for a touchdown.
Get all the action inside the 20 with the Red Zone channel. Order NFL Sunday Ticket Max and save $100 off the regular season price. Call 1-800-GET-SPORTS or go to DirecTV.com/NFL.
Montana State defense holding as Chris Leiter misses a short field goal. We are scoreless in Missoula. The brawl of the wild, Montana and Montana State. We want to know, Root Sports wants to know, where you're watching the brawl of the wild from today. Text us your name and where you're at to 733-733. And we'll post your answers throughout the broadcast. And we'd like to welcome all the fans and alumni today watching at over 80 watch parties around the country. Stan said there's one of your neck of the woods in the Denver area, an establishment called Brooklyn's. They've got Montana State and Montana fans watching that game together. Denarius McGee, first down. John Ellis with a reception. And Ellis out to the 29-yard line. 9-yard gain. Anthony Goodwin with the coverage for Montana.
See the nice outcut. The ball's low, but a nice job of going down with the hands. Look at that by Ellis on the outcut. Controls the ball.
John Ellis, 43 receptions coming into the game, leading the club with 5 TD catches. McGee with a little pressure as Josh Harris was coming in. McGee unable to connect with Cody Kirk.
That's a nice job. When the tackle goes away, you're going to see Josh Harris, collapse his backside and does a nice job attacking the quarterback. Doesn't leave his feet, doesn't fall for any shenanigans, but runs right through the quarterback, hurrying the throw by McGee.
So third down, a yard to go for Montana State. Whistles.
Maybe a false start. and Quinn Catalano.
Catalano, the starting right guard, a 6'4 sophomore out of San Diego.
Boy, guys, that bails Montana State out because they would not have gotten that first down, but because it's a dead ball foul, they'll have to replay the down and they'll have another shot at it.
Our referee today is Tom Frazier. We have not seen, to the best of my knowledge, and we're not sure if we will see, Tanner Bleskin, top wide receiver for Montana State, suffering a hip pointer last week in the win at home against Portland State. He was going through warm-ups, looked pretty good, but that really doesn't tell the entire story from our perspective. So hopefully Tanner Bleskin will be able to make an appearance in this game, the junior out of Great Falls.
We also have to take into account where they're headed next weekend. They got the playoffs looming. I mean, do you really want to risk having that guy be out of your lineup for multiple weeks?
So Bleskin out, additional stats today for Kruiz Siewing and also Brian Floodkettle. Third down and six. McGee feeling the heat. Still on his feet, but down he goes, well short of the first down. Good defense. Brock Coyle in on the play. John Cannon got it.
Guys, you see this. You think they have an eye for Denarius McGee. As soon as he stepped up in the pocket, you saw a swarm of Grizzly defenders corral him. They knew where he had to get to, and they were not about to let him escape too many tackles.
Well, Jay, I don't know if you saw, but he had Kruiz Siewing on that little short in route on the other side, which would have been well enough for a first down.
Perez to punt away to win. Good signals for a fair catch. Makes it at the 33-yard line. 8:23 left in the opening quarter here in Missoula. It is scoreless in the brawl of the Wild.
I know absolutely nothing about this sport.
Whoa! Here's the adrenaline rush. Feels good, don't it?
Welcome to the team.
Hey, Sheldon.
Who are you again?
I'm your girlfriend.
Are you serious about this?
What does it look like to you?
It looks like a wrestler skinned my friend Sheldon and is wearing him like a tracksuit.
Meet Figgle, the free app that rewards you simply for watching DirecTV. Just check in to your favorite shows and start earning points towards a mocha latte, a designer tee, or a trip across the Mediterranean Sea. Hey, they're your points. You choose how to spend them. Download the free Figgle app today and enter promo code DirecTV to unleash exclusive offers and 5,000 bonus points. DirecTV and Figgle. You love TV. Isn't it time TV loved you back?
Every week, the Audience Network brings you special previews of some of the best shows available on DirecTV. This week, see a marathon of the entire first season of BBC America's The Hour, the Golden Globe-nominated spy thriller set in the world of 1950s television journalism.
They will kill me if they know I'm talking to you.
Don't miss a BBC America event on the Audience Network.
Big Sky Football on Root Sports is brought to you by CenturyLink, a different kind of communications company. CenturyLink, your link to what's next. By First Interstate Bank, neighbors helping neighbors in the place we call home. And by BNSF, the engine that connects us. And by Ford, we are local. That is it. Say Montana, not sure what does on this November day. Great to have you with us on Root Sports, 112th edition of the Brawl of the Wild. Second offensive possession for the Montana Grizzlies on first down. Smithwick Hand with a pitch inside to Dan Moore, and the ball is fumbled. Montana State with the recovery. And the first mistake in the game made by Montana.
It's a double read option play. You can either pitch back or go forward. And he pitches it forward to Dan Moore, but you're going to watch Jody Owens come across in shadow. Just beats the block there. John Schmang gets to the play and strips that ball. Right there comes up fights off the block to number 74, John Smang, and makes that play. And that's a huge play by the All-American.
And that ball was recovered by Cole Moore, one of the starting linebackers for Montana State. So a huge play. That's the second takeaway this season for Moore, who also has an interception on first down. McGee. Pressure coming, going deep for John Ellison. Overshoots him. Good coverage by Bo Tully for Montana.
And that's a nice job by Bo Tully, not sucking up into the run. If you watch that first couple, those first couple drives, he's one of the first secondary players up into the fray, getting in there, hitting guys, but doing a nice job reading his keys, staying back in that deep third.
Look at Bo Tully right there, a 6'2" junior out of Meade High School in Spokane. Leading his team with two interceptions this season, along with one of the starting quarterbacks, Sean Murray. And movement, it looks like, on the offensive line for the Bobcats. And that goes against John Weidenauer, the starting left tackle, a redshirt freshman out of Twin Bridges High School, Twin Bridges, Montana. He started every game this season. Left side of that line, Jason Stiles is a young one with Weidenauer and Gadecki, both redshirt freshmen.
Yeah, they had an opportunity early on to see what they had in these guys. Gadecki filled in for an injured Matt Devereaux early on. They've really done a much better job than people anticipated.
Second and 15, and wow, what a hit by Alex Benneman on the intended receiver, and a flag coming in on the play. We'll see if this goes against Benneman.
Guys, it's going to come when he threw the ball up in the air afterwards in celebration. That's where that flag came in, right after he did that.
Well, they're going to try to set the screen to Lorenzo Davis. You see him circle back in underneath, and a nice job of reading it by Benneman, and meets him right at the point of the football, and man, took his head off, and Jay, that's what I saw. It looked like it was a little bit helmet-to-helmet contact, but it's hard to say right there when that ball's in the air and two guys are going for it at the same time.
Well, and the flag came late enough that it's tough to tell if it was the celebration afterwards or that hit, but in a game like this, all sorts of emotions, there's not going to be a whole lot of guys holding back on opportunities to get one under the chin.
Saw Benneman pleading his case. Now Alex reaching out to the crowd to make some noise after the penalty. First down and 10, Montana State at the Montana 35. Handoff and not much there for Lorenzo Davis. Maybe a yard. Brock Coyle in on the stop for the Grizzlies.
Coyle doing a nice job, as you saw Davis start to stumble up. But right now, this, the front two, not even the front four with Wagaman and Harris, but Benneman and Takai are eating the line up, forcing double teams, which is allowing everybody to roam free and do a great job playing backwards.
No gain on first down. McGee, Ellis, open. And Ellis down to the 26-yard line. Put a move on to Joshua Denard.
Once again, we see an extra couple of yards when there's a DB right there to make the tackle. Denard's got to stop that play, but you see Tripp come in with the punch, try to get that ball out, trying to create that turnover, get the ball back to his offense.
Third down and one coming up for the Bobcats. Trey Robinson, Cody Kirk in the backfield with McGee. The stoppage of play, but
well, the play clock is at zeros.
Again.
Play clock is at zeros. They never reset
the play clock. It is rolling now at 15 seconds. And again, movement on the line. And look at Denarius McGee get right into the face of John Weidenauer. We saw the tight end Lee Perkins start to shift, and Weidenauer reacting to Perkins' movement, it appeared.
Well, this is something Coach Ash talked about, is they were concerned with communication. And understanding at their facility, they have speakers, they could create all this noise, but when you get out here and all this energy is happening, it's hard to set in there. So as a quarterback, you want to work silent counts, quick counts, get them out of their stance, allow them to get out and hit somebody.
Three penalties in the game for Montana State. Third down. Open target. Flatkett does a terrific job hanging on to the football. That'll be a first down for Montana State. Joshua Denard with the coverage and the stop for the Grizzlies.
And Jace, what'd you like about this? Big, big body, and what's he do? He gets between the ball and the defenders making that play.
Yeah, big security blanket for a quarterback when you got a big target like that in short yardage situations.
18th catch this season for Flatketter. McGee tucks it away. Panagata finishes off the play as McGee is dropped for a loss. Brock Coyle also there.
We talked about earlier on the same type of play. We saw Josh Harris maintain his ground coverage and stay on the ground, run through the quarterback. This time, Denarius makes him practice his jump shot. He gets up in the air. Lucky for him, Cannon got it, and the rest of the corps was right behind him.
Second down and 10. Montana showing blitz. Here it comes. McGee with time, backside pressure, open target. But the football dropped inside the 10-yard line by John Ellis. Very good throw by McGee.
And this is a great bench route. You're going to see the nice end cut. It comes back out, gets back to the sideline, but takes his eye off a little bit. The one thing they're worried with or they're concerned about is that sun coming into that part of the field. When you turn back, you're looking right in the sun. But well-delivered ball, you've got to make that catch if you're Ellis.
Third down and 10. McGee, pressure up the middle. Keeping the play alive and throwing over his intended receiver, Kruiz Siewing, at the 6-yard line. Although they did not complete that pass, guys, a great example of what Denarius McGee can do to keep a play going.
Absolutely, and they get Wagaman down at the defensive tackle spot, and he shows a little bit too much quickness there for Gadecki. But McGee able to keep the play going. Elongate the play, make a play, but overthrows the ball.
Rory Perez on for the field goal, 42 yards. He's 4 of 4 this season, between 40 and 49 with a long of 45. The kick is up, and the kick is good. Rory Perez splitting the uprights in Montana State with the initial lead in the Brawl of the Wild with 5:22 left to play in the first quarter.
Ford has the freshest lineup in America, so we're at the mall celebrating.
Have you seen an Escape before?
I haven't.
Everything is hands-free. You just put your foot under there like that.
I like that it's sleek and not super boxy.
Active Park Assist means you can parallel park without your hands on the steering wheel.
Perfect.
How many miles on the highway?
33.
That's correct.
Oh, man.
Get an all-new 2013 Ford Escape with up to $2,000 total cash back. That's $2,000 cash back on Escape. So don't miss the Ford year-end celebration. On now at your local Ford store.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema. Meet the men of the watch. Stiller.
We're pillars of the community.
I need your pillar in my community.
I don't know what that means.
Vaughn.
Hell no, it's a weeknight.
Are you serious? I hate it here.
That's my little princess. That's my little angel.
Hill.
I'm gonna report each and every one of you.
Except for those two hot girls I was talking to. Did they say anything when I walked away? Did they say, like, he was nice or he was handsome? Because there's a big difference.
The Watch. Movies start at Channel 125.
Meet Figgle, the free app that rewards you simply for watching DirecTV. Just check in to your favorite shows and start earning points towards a mocha latte, a designer tee, or a trip across the Mediterranean Sea. Hey, they're your points. You choose how to spend them. Download the free Figgle app today and enter promo code DirecTV to unleash exclusive offers and 4,000 bonus points. DirecTV and Figgle. You love TV. Isn't it time TV loved you back?
On Root Sports College Football. Seahawks All Access this week on Root Sports.
I am a Bobcat. I am Montana State.
I am a Grizzly. I am Montana.
And welcome back to Washington Grizzly Stadium. 5:22 left in the first quarter. Montana State with a 3-0 lead over Montana as the Bobcats cash in on the fumble by Dan Moore. They go 21 yards in 9 plays as Perez connects on the 42-yard field goal. And said there have been some fumble issues, unfortunately, this season for Dan Moore.
Yeah, we had him early in the year against NAU, had a couple fumbles, but he'll bounce back.
Kemp taking a knee in the end zone. Ball to come out to the 25-yard line. Time now for today's players to watch, brought to you by Quicken Loans. Sam Gratton, senior, one of 12 for Montana, one of the top receivers in school history. Dan Moore, who we just referred to, back in action after missing 5 games with a high ankle sprain. Brad Daly has really been on a terrific roll the last few games for Montana State. So bookends between Daly and Tribice, very dangerous. And Jody Owens, one of the top linebackers, and there are a lot of good ones in the Big Sky Conference. So down 3, Shea Smithwick hand brings his Grizzlies offense back out on the field. Handoff. And that's Jordan Canada. A good pickup on first down, brought down by Joel Fuller for the Bobcats. 7-yard gain for Canada. Handoff again, Canada again, but there to greet him, Zach Minner, the outstanding defensive tackle, the senior out of Glendale, Arizona for Montana State.
He is just now getting it at full strength, and a little bit of an awkward tackle there on Canada, kind of got rolled over on that ankle by Mentor, but watch Mentor just take the block on and just
my mic is dead.
Come inside and just dominate the play. I mean, there's inside move, inside charge, and you can't have that if you've got a play going on the inside zone.
Third down and 4 after the 1-yard loss. Smithwick hand. Good coverage. He connects with Hardy, but short of the first down. Jody Owens on the coverage. Montana is going to be short. Actually, no, the mark, a favorable one for the Grizzlies, so it is good enough for a first down.
I tell you, what a terrific hands catch by Hardy. Still don't know why. This guy needs more balls. You got to throw this big man the balls. Great hands and a good tight end route runner.
Sam Bratt with a reception. Lunges forward. And a gain of 5 yards. Shea Smithwick hand is now 4 of 7 passing here in the first quarter. Deontay Flowers with the tackle for the Bobcats.
Good to see him get on track and get going. I mean, that fit ball that he threw to Hardy was one of the best throws we've seen him make.
Here goes Peter Wynn. Not much there. Jody Owens in on the stop. Weak side linebacker, top tackler for this Bobcat team, coming in with 70 tackles, also leading the club with 3 forced fumbles. Really an impact player, a senior out of Mesquite, Texas. Another third down coming up for the Grizz. Gerald Kemp in motion. Hand off to Wynn. And boy, when you look at him, that is not the epitome of a power back, but when he needs to unload, he can unload. And he gets the first down
Montana. He doesn't mess around here. Look at him. Get right up in Joe Fuller's face, and Brad Daly takes them both on, drags them across for the first down. And you talk about a guy at all of 5-0, 100-0 pounds, 182. I mean, he is explosive.
Smithwick hand did not go with the pitch to Cam Warren. Brad Daly with the tackle as we head down to the field to check in with Jenny Kavner.
Yeah, guys, Shea Smithwick hand. This is his first Cat Grizz game, but he is no stranger to the rivalry as his dad played for Montana. He remembers the first time that the Grizz lost to the Cats. He was 11 years old. He said he remembers going outside crying and just throwing the football against the wall over and over. Perhaps he knew he might be in a situation to lead the Grizz to a victory, guys.
Jenny, thank you so much. Very nice catch that time by Ellis Henderson. Coverage by Darius Jones. Not enough yardage for a first down, a gain of 7 for Montana.
Brings up a third and short, which is very manageable. It gives you a lot of different options if you're Coach Rosenbaum.
Edward Hand directing traffic as Sam Gratt comes from the left side to the right side of the formation. Third down and 2. Hand off to Wynn. First down and more. Peter Wynn. Wynn inside the 20. Wynn takes it all the way. Touchdown, Montana. Yard touchdown run for Peter Wynn, who's off to a terrific start here today. 6 carries for 88 yards. And that's what you dream about, guys, when you're a senior and you're playing your last home game.
It really is. And a guy that's just stuck with the program, done everything right. And when he hits that hole, man, he makes that one cut, makes a defender miss, and he is out the gate. Terrific job blocking up front by the big nasties.
Fifth rushing touchdown this season. Extra point hits the upright but goes through. So a break for the Grizzlies at Chris Leiter. And a 7-3 Montana lead with 2:04 left to play in the first quarter. As you get a good look at Peter Wynn.
It's one of those plays that they run often, just an inside zone. You see the zone block there. Good kick out by big 77 Spang. It does a nice job. And I tell you what, once he gets to that second level, it is over with.
Well, and said we talked about with the coach earlier in the week, they needed Joel Fuller from that safety spot to play well against the run. That time wasn't in the box like we expected him to be, but he's got to be that open field tackle guy. And Peter Wynn, a very shifty runner, to where he's made his money at running for Montana in the last 4 years, gives him one little shake and he's off to the races.
Well, you've got to close that gap. That's a great point, Jason. Got to close the gap in that zone area. When you're coming up to fill that run, if you're Fuller or any of the other DBs, you've got to get in there and close the space down. You can't leave them with a lot of room because you probably couldn't touch the little guy in the phone booth, man.
9 plays, 75 yards, 3:18, capped off by Wynn's 47-yard touchdown run. And you see Peter about to move up the ladder in terms of career rushing at Montana, closing in on 2,000 career rushing yards. So what an outstanding first quarter for Peter Wynn, 88 yards rushing and that touchdown. This is Everett Gilbert dropping the ball at the 1. He'll take a knee. Time now for today's play.
Guys, it's a safety.
Brought to you by Quicken Loans. We'll get to that in a moment. I wasn't quite sure how they were going to rule that, Jason, whether or not the momentum of the ball took it into the end zone.
No, he was set up at about the 1.5-yard line to receive that kick, fumbled it on his own, went backwards, and then tried to down it in the end zone.
There's the line there. You're going to see the ball roll across the goal line. And at this point, you have to get out of there. You can't kneel it at that point. That's a colossal mistake.
Now it's been ruled a touchback. And that's, I did not see a safety signal initially as the play occurred.
Yeah, well, the referee spotted the ball in the end zone initially. Oh, yeah, after some conversation signaled the safety, but then the conversation with the officiating crew was surrounding did he have possession before it went into the end zone. They considered it a muff as opposed to possession, which is why they overruled it and then called a touchback.
Looking at it, it's a good call because he really never controlled that ball. It went right through the wickets. But man, what a huge break for the Bobcats.
Who's has the biggest sigh of relief right now in Washington Grizzly Stadium is Everett Gilbert. First down and 10 at the 25. McGee with the play fake to Kirk. Open target. And the reception by Tanner Bleskin, who has checked into the game as we take a look at our players to watch. Brought to you by Quicken Loans. Lorenzo Davis, senior running back for Montana State. John Ellis already making an impact felt here in the first quarter. Wagonman, one of the top, in fact, tied with Caleb Schreibice. Schreibice is the top sack man in all the conferences. Cody Kirk gets within a yard of a first down.
Guys, when they came off the field after the last drive, Coach Jason McIndoe opened up a can of you-know-what with his offensive linemen and just absolutely let him have it. Really looking at John Weidenauer, a big part of that. But after he left, Sean Sampson, that center, he's the glue of that offensive line, got these guys together. So if you see a little more hop in their step, you'll know why.
Second down in the yard. Flatketter, the intended receiver. Over a shot, Joshua Denard with the coverage. 1:16 left to play in the first quarter here in Missoula.
I tell you, if Denard's a little tighter on that coverage, that could go the other way, because Denarius McGee never looked to that side of the field until he cranked to throw it.
Denarius with 8 interceptions this year. We saw him throw a pick six against Eastern Washington, the only loss this season for Montana State. That happened at Bobcat Stadium, 3rd down and 1. Maybe another procedure call.
If you're a tight end and you're off the ball there and you move, just do a little short motion and come right back to your spot. You see him flinch here, and the defense is always going to point that out. But if you're off the ball receiver there, which he was, do a little motion or step back and readjust yourself.
That went against Alex Eckhoff, number 97. He will also wear number 71 when he is in as an offensive lineman. McGee, 3rd down, dumps it off to Kirk. And unable to get past Joshua Denard. 5'11", 180 sophomore out of Phoenix's Brophy Prep. And the Bobcats will be forced to punt.
That's a real good open field tackle there on Cody Kirk. And the one thing you could say, he hasn't been able to get on track, Cody Kirk.
Well, and keep in mind, too, this is a Montana State team that has just been lights out on 3rd down throughout this season, amongst the best in the country, well in excess of 50% conversions. And Montana early on in this ball game has been very stout on 3rd down.
Perez on the punt. Win back to receive for Montana. Confusion again.
It's got to be the play
on
call.
The field. Montana State has already been. Make that penalty number 5 for 25 yards for Montana State. So Perez will back up 5 yards. Wynn stands back near his 20-yard line.
How do you miss that big thing right there? That thing right there is what tells you what's going on. You've got to see those. They're right in front of the snapper. They're in front of the quarterbacks. Can't miss those. I mean, every yard in this rivalry counts, man. You can't give them away.
So the punt will hold to the 2nd quarter. That's the end of the 1st quarter here in the Brawl of the Wild. Montana leading Montana State 7-3.
Political intrigue.
I am not the enemy here. You do not want to make me one.
An ally betrayed.
I will never forgive you for this.
A plot for revenge.
After everything you did to him, and now you plot deadly revenge?
Only one show can bring you this kind of drama. Call me Fitz.
Fitz o'clock. I'm a councilman now.
Why are we in a naked lady bar?
Die! Die! Why won't you die?
An all-new Call Me Fitz, Tuesday, November 27th, on the Audience Network.
Hey, DirecTV customers, are you ready for another season of nonstop NFL action on DirecTV's Red Zone channel? Each Sunday, we'll take you around the league for live look-ins on every game.
Oh, what a catch!
This is unbelievable.
He's got it for a touchdown.
Get all the action inside the 20 with the Red Zone channel. Order NFL Sunday Ticket Max and save $100 off the regular season price. Call 1-800-GET-SPORTS or go to DirecTV.com/NFL.
I know absolutely nothing about this sport.
Whoa! Here's the adrenaline rush. Feels good, don't it?
Welcome to the team.
Hey, Sheldon.
Who are you again?
I'm your girlfriend.
Are you serious?
serious about this?
What does it look like to you?
It looks like a wrestler skinned my friend Sheldon and is wearing him like a tracksuit.
We play to win, but it's bigger than winning. It's about authenticity, being true to yourself, genuine dreams and a country big enough to fit them, values and hard work, giving your best and giving back, working together, building a tradition bigger than any one of us, and showing the world every day who we are and how we play. We're Big Sky. We are the heart of the American West.
Tailgate Montana style. Welcome back to Missoula, Washington Grizzly Stadium. We will seek that person out post-game. The Grizz in front of the Cats, 7-3, as we get ready for the start of the second quarter. With Rory Perez on to punt for Montana State, Peter Wimp back deep to receive for the Grizzlies. High snap. Wynn instructing his teammates, get out of the way of the football. The ball will be down inside the 25-yard line as we take a look at our four-game summary. Get the four-point lead for the Grizzlies. Third down, so that's a very interesting stat. 1 of 5 Montana State offensively, and they came into this game second best in the Big Sky Conference at 53%. And look at the efficiency, 4 of 5 third downs converted for Montana. As Shea Smith-Wick hand brings his club to the line. First and 10 from the 24-yard line. Greg Hardy, the tight end, in motion. Hand off near sideline. And forced out. Jordan Canada brought down by Darius Jones.
Looked like there was going to be nothing there. He just runs the edge and gets around Brad Daly to pick up few good yards. I mean, that play looked dead from the start.
Well, and said another missed tackle by Joe Fuller right at the point of attack. Jordan Canada just beat it with speed.
7-yard gain, second down and 3. Canada short of the first down. Brad Daly with the stop. Junior out of Helena's Capital High School. 19 tackles, 3.5 sacks, 1 fumble recovery the last 4 games for Daly. Third down and 1 yard. Smith-Wick hand on the keeper. Lunges forward out to the 35 and gets a first down for Montana. 2-yard pickup for Smith-Wick hand.
Does just enough. I mean, you watch him, you're like, oh, this guy's not athletic, but he understands what he needs to get. He makes a good decision, gets upfield, picks up the first down, and was outflanked out there on the edge, but the linebacker made a good choice.
The Baspar's sideline. Bryce Carver with the reception. Jody Owens, Darius Jones in on the stop.
What a great block by senior tight end and the co-captain Greg Hardy to spring that one. That's what you need on those bubble screens. Just need one block to get that 6-7 yards. That's the reason why they have the big fella out there.
6-yard gain, first catch today for Carver. Smith-Wick hand. Maybe 1 yard on that play. Daly, one of the Bobcats there. Schreibice as well. Also number 23, Jody Owens. Look at some of the Montana State defensive numbers, where they rank in the Big Sky Conference. Rushing yards allowed at 88.8. With Peter Wynn at 88 in the first quarter all by himself. Hand off to Canada right up the middle. First down. Montana, Jody Owens with the tackle.
And that is every bit of John Schmang Hendrickson, Kelby Oyland, William Pales, and Kissler just dominating up front. And there is absolutely zero penetration coming from the Bobcats.
Out to Cam Warren. And nothing doing that time. James Andrews, backup cornerback, making the stop, a senior out of Rockwall, Texas.
And that is the way you tackle in the open field. He closed the gap, didn't allow for much space from the receiver. Watch him get up in his face early, shimmies, and gets him down to the ground early. That's a nice play.
Hand off win. Nowhere to go. Schreibeis with the tackle.
Guys, one of the few times we've seen Montana now in third and long situation, they've really been able to control things up front and get some good gains on first and second down to open up that playbook. But this is where Montana State makes their money. This is where Caleb Schreibeis can pin his ears back and get after with those 11 sacks.
They're down and 11. Plenty of ball back of the way, caught by an offensive lineman. That was William Pales. Flags on the play. Smithwick hand hit as he was throwing the football.
Yeah, but they're thinking it's going to be a legal touching. Now they'll talk about it to determine whether it was a fumble or an actual forward pass.
It's got to be a fumble.
Tom Frazier, a referee today. Take a look and see who got to Smithwick hand.
It's right off the inside edge. I believe it was Brian Bignell. Number 99 with the pressure.
Senior out of Helena, who has five sacks this season, nearly got his sixth. Stephen Shaw on to punt. Sean Johnson back deep to receive for the Bobcats. Johnson trying to break a couple of tackles and then brought down. Flags on the field. Nate Harris with the tackle. Number 11 in special teams coverage for Nate. No flag on the play. Timeout here at Washington Grizzly Stadium. When we come back, Denarius McGee will have his Bobcat offense back on the field.
Ford has the freshest lineup in America, so we're at the mall celebrating. Have you seen the new Focus?
I walked in and it was just like,
wow.
Seriously fun to drive. 40 miles a gallon on the highway.
40 miles a gallon?
Sync technology, 10,000 separate commands. So you can boss it around, Sasha, to your heart's content.
Are these made here?
Right here in the store. Yeah, a small group of elves come in.
Lease a 2013 Focus for just $159 a month. That's $159 a month on Focus. Don't miss the Ford year-end celebration. On now at your local Ford store.
Meet Figgle, the free app that rewards you simply for watching DirecTV. Just check in to your favorite shows and start earning points towards a mocha latte, a designer tee, or a trip across the Mediterranean Sea. Hey, they're your points. You choose how to spend them. Download the free Figgle app today and enter promo code DirecTV to unleash exclusive offers and 5,000 bonus points. DirecTV and Figgle. You love TV. Isn't it time TV loved you back?
Every week, the Audience Network brings you special previews of some of the best shows available on DirecTV. This week, see a marathon of the entire first season of BBC America's The Hour, the Golden Globe-nominated spy thriller set in the world of 1950s television journalism.
They will kill me if they know I'm talking to you.
Don't miss a BBC America event on the Audience Network.
Grizzlies in front of the Bobcats, 7-3, 11:31 left in the first half here in Missoula. Time now for today's trivia question. What is the average temperature for the Brawl of the Wild? A, 12 degrees, B, 23 degrees, C, 29 degrees, or D, 35 degrees? Let us know at 733-733. About the last 4 years, the temperature had been trending down under 10 degrees last season. Happy to say we do not have that today. Cody Kirk finally brought down by Sean Murray out near the 27-yard line. Gain of about five. Warmest temperature ever for a Brawl of the Wild. We won't get there. 67 degrees. Coldest morning temperature of a game day, -5. Game time temperature, 2 degrees. And in 79, they had 5 inches of snow. Second down at 5. McGee going for Flatketter. Makes a nice adjustment on the football as he beats Murray on the play. Again, out to the 41-yard line. 14-yard pickup for Montana State.
And you see how early McGee throws his football. It's just a basic back shoulder route and a good job of being on the same page with your quarterback by Flatketter.
Cody Kirk stacked up. Now McGee's a blocker. Oh, terrific ankle tackle by Sean Murray as he brings Cody Kirk down. But a good pickup on first down for the Bobcats.
Something that they haven't been able to do.
Some of our early trivia results in. Now I guessed 29 degrees, which seems plenty cold enough. Second down and 4. And again, flags.
Hey guys, Trey Robinson flinched from that. And Denarius McGee, the last few weeks I've seen him much more demonstrative with his teammates on the field. If there's a missed block, these false starts, you can tell the frustration's getting to him a little bit. But again, set a guy off the ball, no reason for him to be jumping, and a little twitch sends him back 5 yards.
6 penalties for 30 yards for Montana State. Denarius McGee, 8 of 14 for 73 yards. No snap. McGee swings it out. Football dropped by Trey Robinson. Timing off right at the start on that play with that low snap. So third down coming up.
And this play, bad throw here, but you're going to watch big number 55 pull out. John Weidenauer. You're going to see him set and then go on the screen. Watch what Cannon Gana does to him. Big man. Not today. I mean, he's giving up a lot of size and weight right there. And just hits him, I mean, catches him right in the chin.
Montana State, 1 of 5 on third down conversions. Looking at 3rd and 9. McGee with time with a target. Flatketter with a catch. First down, Montana State. Matt Hermanson with the tackle for the Grizzlies.
This is the problem when you run zone underneath zone. Flatketter's going to run into this area. You're going to see him wrap around the linebacker, Jordan Tripp, who runs too wide and is not really looking up the back. You're going to see Tripp pass by. There's the window and a well-delivered ball on time by McGee.
16-yard gain on the play. In Montana territory, Cody Kirk and nowhere to go. Target to Kai, number 95. There to bring Kirk down. Tonga is 6'2", 301-pound sophomore out of Waipahu, Hawaii. 2 sacks, 2 fumble recoveries this season. Injured that left elbow 2 weeks ago at Weber State. Thought that might be a serious one, but he actually returned to that game and is doing well. Loss of a yard, second down and 11. McGee. Looks right. Going for Flatketter, and he has the catch inside the 25-yard line as he beats Anthony Goodwin on the play. And Brian Flatketter with his 4th catch here in the first half.
Well, once again, a great opportunity for Denarius McGee to step into the throw. Montana's not been able to make him uncomfortable in the pocket all that time. And he's going to be able to deliver strikes, especially these big receivers. Flatketter finding that open spot in the zone once again.
26-yard gain. McGee, 10 of 17, 115 yards. Wildcat formation. Snap to Kirk. Drives down near the 15, hauled down by Alex Beneman. junior out of Denver, as we head down to the field and connect with Jen Mueller. Hey, Jen.
Well, Tom, you were talking about the weather earlier today. I think it was about 47 when we got here to the stadium, but now the entire Montana State sideline is in the shade. It's dropped at least 5 degrees in the last 20 minutes, and we're seeing guys go for hand warmers, although compared to last week's conditions, it's probably still downright balmy for the Cats.
Last week at home against Portland State, a game time temperature of 12 with a wind chill of -4. So this is a vast improvement. McGee out of the shotgun. Blitz coming, picked up nicely, wide open in the end zone. Touchdown, Montana State, Kruiz Siewing. Second touchdown catch on the season for Kruiz Siewing. Had his first last week in the blowout victory against Portland State. And the guy they were looking to go to a little bit more today said because of the injury issue with Bleskin.
And once again, they go back to the corner route. The defensive backs cannot handle the receivers. They're giving too much space, but right there, there's a pass off. The safety doesn't get the transfer. And wide open on the corner route is Kruiz Siewing.
Alex Benneman shaken up on the play. Looks like it might be in. I thought at first he was maybe favoring his right arm or right shoulder, but that may not be the case as Rory Perez comes on for the extra point following the 16-yard touchdown pass. Darius McGee to Kruiz Siewing. For Darius McGee, touchdown pass number 21 on the season. Has thrown a touchdown pass in every game he has played with one exception. That was 2 weeks ago at Sac State. Perez with the extra point and the 10-7 lead for the second-rated team in the nation, Montana State, as Darius McGee had time and had a wide-open Kruiz Siewing to connect with.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema, meet the men of the watch. Stiller.
We're pillars of the community.
I need your pillar in my community.
I don't know what that means.
Vaughn.
Hell no, it's a weeknight.
Are you serious? I hate it here.
That's my little princess. That's my little angel.
Hill.
I'm gonna report each and every one of you.
Except for those two hot girls I was talking to. Did they say anything when I walked away? Did they say, like, he was nice or he was handsome? Because there's a big difference.
The Watch. Movies start at Channel 125.
Meet Viggle, the free app that rewards you simply for watching DirecTV. Just check in to your favorite shows and start earning points towards a mocha latte, a designer tee, or a trip across the Mediterranean Sea. Hey, they're your points. You choose how to spend them. Download the free Viggle app today and enter promo code DirecTV to unleash exclusive offers and 4,000 bonus points. DirecTV and Viggle. You love TV. Isn't it time TV loved you back?
We are the Big Sky champs.
You satisfied?
You have no idea.
We put in the work.
We're here to repeat.
Get in your seats. You're ready for a ride.
Are you ready?
We are Montana.
Montana State reclaims the lead over Montana, 10-7, 7:54 left in the first half. Your help with Hurricane Sandy is needed. Text the words Red Cross to 90999 to give $10 to American Red Cross Disaster Relief, which helps people affected by natural disasters. Please consider making a donation today to help the thousands of people who've been affected by these disasters. Welcome back to Missoula, along with Sed Bonner, Jason Stiles, Jenny Kavnar, Jen Mueller. I'm Tom Glasgow. Great to have you with us on Root Sports. Number two team in FCS football, the Montana State Bobcats, with a 16-yard touchdown pass to Denarius McGee to Kruiz Siewing, leading their arch rivals, the Montana Grizzlies, 10-7. A.J. Silver with the kickoff. Taken by Gerald Kemp at the five. Full head of steam for Kemp. Knocked down around the 28-yard line. Good tackle that time by Michael Foster. Right now, let's check in with Brad Adam at the Ford Sports Desk.
Well, Tom, thank you very much. Yeah, we're keeping our eye on other Big Sky games. Remember, entering play today, four teams tied atop the conference lead at 4-1. Eastern Washington taking on Portland State in the Rose City. Win by the Eagles. We'll give them a share of that conference lead right now. Portland State on top, 13-0. DJ Adams, two short touchdown runs. They miss a point after attempt, but not haunting them now when they do lead 13-0. Back to Missoula, Tom said.
Brad, thanks so much. First down and 10 for the Grizz. Smithwick hand with a completion. Out across the 35-yard line. He connects with Sam Gratton. Take a look at the standings in the conference. On this final week of league play, Montana State, Cal Poly, Eastern Washington, Northern Arizona, all tied up. Cal Poly at NAU today. And Eastern Washington on the road to face Portland State. So within a few hours, it'll all be settled. See who shares the Big Sky Conference title.
Hey, Eastern Washington's really dug themselves a hole the last few weeks. Last week at home, falling down to UC Davis and having to come back in the second half, and already down 13. And Portland is a big surprise, especially after the way Portland showed up in Bozeman.
That's starting center for Montana, Kelby Oyland, junior out of Ferris High School in Spokane. He, along with John Cannon, got it. Backup linebacker Nick Holt did not play in the Weber State game 2 weeks ago. They were suspended for that game. A one-game suspension, and there you see Kelby. Now going out of our screen and making his way off the field. Logan Hines will come on to play center, and Hines did a very good job, said at Weber State in a game that we had, filling in for Kelby.
He really did, and that's a position they're not really concerned with. Not that Kelby Oyland isn't the starter and the leader on that team, but Hines did a terrific job at Weber State.
Second down and a yard. And a first down for the Grizzlies out to the 40-yard line. Peter Wynn adds to his rushing total today.
I'd like to see Joe Fuller in that type of position right there, getting up, filling that hole early. Even though Wynn picked up the first down, Fuller is active and into the lane early.
It's a lateral trick play. Hardy throwing the pass and throwing it away in the area of Ellis Henderson.
This is just a smart play. Really had nothing to do. Deontay Flowers stays at home. But you knew something was afoot when Hardy was behind the line of scrimmage catching the ball. You see Flowers, deeper than the deepest, did a nice job of staying home on that trick play.
Second down and 10. I think we'll see another trick play or two before this one is over. And off to Wynn. Busting it around the right edge. Flag on the play. Beffley making the tackle for Montana State. Possibly a face mask is Peter Wynn. North of 90 yards rushing today.
Holding 23. Offense. 10-yard penalty. Check it out.
Cam Warren with a holding penalty.
Tough call there. You see the speed of Schreibeis, Beffley. I mean, those guys were running down, and they left a lot later than Peter Wynn did. They were able to track him down across the field. This team has such great lateral speed. I'm talking about the Bobcats, it's hard to go lateral.
Schreibeis and Zach Wagenman coming into this game, co-leaders in sacks in the Big Sky Conference with 11 each. Second and long. Not much there for Montana's Gerald Kemp. Darius Jones with the tackle.
Brings up a third and short, but since Kemp has worked his way back into the lineup, he's been a real contributor on special teams. You see there, using his big physical presence as a receiver. Got to find ways to get that young man the ball.
Became eligible for the Idaho State game. So played against Idaho State, Weber State. Third and 11. Smithwick hand by some time. Out to Joey Counts. And Counts near the 45-yard line, but well short of a Montana first down. And the punt team will come on for the Grizzlies.
It's a good job of not losing any yards. And now it's a situation where you're going to try to bang it out for some field position.
Second punt coming up for Stephen Shaw. His first one covering 34 yards with Sean Johnson to receive for the Bobcats standing at his 15-yard line. Johnson last week with a punt return for a touchdown. This time signals for the fair catch and makes it at the 13-yard line. Jenny Kavnar has a special guest. Jenny?
Special indeed. The governor of Montana, Governor Schweitzer, with me. Now, you're finishing your second term here in a couple weeks, so I think that's why you're now allowed to wear the Bobcat jersey. You do not have to be reelected. Is that the deal?
I always wear Bobcat. Both Nancy and I, my wife, we're Bobcats. Win or lose, we're with the Bobcats.
As an alumni, you're allowed to do that. Now, you've seen eight of these games. How great is it for the state of Montana?
It's a great rivalry, and this goes back over 100 years. And it doesn't matter what your record is, when the Bobcats and Grizzlies play, everything's off the table. These kids started in third grade as Grizzlies or Bobcats. They played against each other in mock games their entire life, and now it's for real.
Well, I'm gonna let you enjoy your last Cat Grizz game as the governor, but before we go, I mean, any special announcements for the future we might wanna make here on Root Sports now that you're done with your governor terms, maybe 2016, anything coming up?
We're gonna take some time at the lake, that's all I'm gonna tell you.
All right, thanks, Governor, so much for joining us, Tom.
Jenny, thanks so much. Is that a lake possibly in Iowa? Probably not. And he's done a really outstanding job as governor of the Treasure State. Darius McGee going deep. And John Ellis open and beating Sean Murray by about a step. Third down coming up for the Bobcats.
Hey, Jason, does it look to you like the receivers are open for the Bobcats, like the secondary is having problems in coverage back here for the Grizzlies?
Well, I think as much as anything, the secondary has been tight for about the first 3 seconds, but there's been no pass rush whatsoever up front for Montana in the last two series.
Good look at Josh Harris, one of two defensive starters, actually two defensive players in the two deep. For that Montana defense, third down and 10. McGee, time in the pocket, going for Bruskin. And Tanner unable to bring it in. Fourth down coming up. John Canningata with a coverage for the Grizzlies. A very good job at the struggles on third down continuing today. For Montana State, now just 2 of 7.
If you're Bluskin there, you've got to continue to work off that route to run away from coverage. You see he settles in the hole instead of accelerating out of it. And after that ball was thrown out in front of him, he stops. The ball goes incomplete.
Keep in mind that hip pointer could also be affecting his ability to accelerate out of that break.
Fourth punt coming up for Perez. He's averaged 40. Peter Wynn drifting back inside his 40. Beats Trey Robinson, has some room. A nice return by Peter Wynn into Montana State territory at the Bobcats' 45-yard line. Multi-dimensional player, top 10 in a number of categories in his career at Montana, Peter Wynn.
Every communications provider is different, but CenturyLink is committed to being a different kind of communications company.
Do what you want when you want to. We all have time with a different kind of connection.
We link people in Fortune 500 companies nationwide and around the world, and we will continue to free you to do more and focus on what matters.
Yeah, link up and go now. Link up and go now.
Political intrigue.
I am not the enemy here. You do not want to make me one.
An ally betrayed.
I will never forgive you for this.
A plot for revenge.
After everything you did to him, and now you plot deadly revenge?
Only one show can bring you this kind of drama.
call me Fitz.
Fitz o'clock. I'm a councilman now.
Why are we in a naked lady bar?
Die! Die! Why won't you die?
An all-new Call Me Fitz, Tuesday, November 27th on the Audience Network.
Hey, DirecTV customers, are you ready for another season of nonstop NFL action on DirecTV's Red Zone channel? Each Sunday, we'll take you around the league for live look-ins on every game.
Oh, what a catch!
This is unbelievable.
He's got it for a touchdown.
Get all the action inside the 20 with the Red Zone channel. Order NFL Sunday Ticket Max and save $100 off the regular season price. Call 1-800-GET-SPORTS or go to DirecTV.com/NFL.
Let's take a look at our four-game summary. First quarter, Montana missing a field goal. Montana State connecting from 42 yards. Rory Perez, and then the first touchdown of the game, Peter Wynn, 47 yards with 2:04 left in the first quarter. And Montana had the 7-3 lead, but the response coming here in the second quarter. Denarius McGee, 16-yard connection to a wide-open Kruiz Siewing. And that's where we stand. 10-7, Cats over the Grizz with 5:08 left to play in the first half in the 112th edition of the Brawl of the Wild. Montana on first down and a 5-yard loss on the play. The carry by Canada and the tackle by Darius Jones.
Darius Jones doing a nice job of fighting off what's supposed to be a block. Not a good effort. Bad angle taken coming down inside by Mitch Saylor. You got to get flat. Get your head across the defender's face and make your block.
Second down and 15. Smithwick hand 11 of 14 passing. Here's keep it on the ground to Canada. Gets the 5 yards back and a yard or two more. 7-yard gain on the play. That'll bring up third down and 8.
I think Mitch Saylor got the message because this last play here, he takes Joe Fuller. Did you see that?
Yeah, 3 yards into the sideline over here.
Watch yourself over there, man. Don't get hurt.
I'm an athlete.
Third down and 8 for Montana at the Bobcats 43-yard line. Smithwick hand. He set himself. And down he goes. Big Brian Bignell with the tackle. Fourth down coming up for the Grizzlies. Nicely done by number 99.
Really was a good job of just continuing to fight. He gets double teamed and fights off. And once again, Joe Fuller having a hard time of wrapping guys up and finishing plays. Bignell finishes it up for him.
Third punt of the game coming up for Stephen Shaw. He's averaged 38 on the first two. Johnson back at his 10-yard line. Signals for the fair catch and makes it around the 5 or 6 yard line. So not really good field position coming up for Denarius McGee and company. Hey, how about this? Free Grizz tattoos yesterday. What's the name of that place? Every Mother's Nightmare Tattoo Parlor. And there you go.
Yeah, we're gonna hold
now that is dedication.
That's commitment. That is forever.
Said, should we break the surprise to our wives now on TV?
No, I'm not doing it.
Okay.
Not doing it.
So would that be surprise or shock?
Yeah, a little bit of both.
And does that mean you're spending an extra day in Missoula or are you able to go home? First down and 10. McGee. Buying time with a rollout. Intended receiver was John Ellis. Coverage by Bo Tully.
And that end zone got really loud down there. Defensive end, Wagaman's waving, the tackles moving early, but Bo Tully has really had done a nice job. He hasn't had a lot of tackles, doesn't have any picks, but he's everywhere he's supposed to be in help coverage and in his lanes.
McGee, 11 of 22, 131 yards passing and one touchdown. Remember, this is a secondary that was torched not that long ago in North Dakota. 660 yards allowed through the air. McGee off the pick, trying to set up a screen, in trouble, and throws the football away.
Widener standing a yard over the line of scrimmage. That should be illegal for a legible man downfield, but They're trying to set the throwback screen. You see Orenzo Davis pop back up, but look at Wagonman's awareness on that backside. Shuts it down.
Good job. What,
he's not just a pass rusher, man. He is a complete football player for a sophomore, very heady.
Good job on that play also by Beneman and Josh Harris. Third down and 10. And this is where it gets really difficult to communicate. Third down conversions, 2 of 7 for the Bobcats. McGee in some trouble. Unloads. Let's see if this is called intentional grounding.
Trey Robinson was right there. They can't make that call.
So the Bobcats.
Intentional grounding, number 7 was in the air.
Trey Robinson's going to circle out of the backfield and end up right here, and that's why there will be no call on this. Even though he swung around, there could be question if it got back to the line of scrimmage now. But that wasn't an issue.
That's your opinion. Now there's 26,000 Grizzly fans here that really are not agreeing with your perspective.
I'm in here giving my opinion. If I was out there amongst them, I might think differently of it.
Rory Perez on for his fifth punt. Win at the Bobcat 45. Signal for the fair catch. It was just one swipe of the arm, but it was clear. Coming up at halftime, we'll get you back to our Ford Sports Desk where Brad Adam is standing by. Let's check in with Brad right now.
All right, Tom, thank you very much. Speaking of halftime, yes, from the Ford Sports Desk, we're going to relive the amazing moments during the conference season. With the Big Sky Plays of the Year, you're also going to meet the grand prize winner in the Big Sky Tailgate Contest. It's all coming your way at halftime from the Northwest Ford Sports Desk. We've sampled a lot of food. We've got the winner back to you guys. And hopefully you get to enjoy some tailgating at halftime out there.
Brad, it is under serious consideration, no doubt about it. And no doubt Montana State was ready for that running play as Peter Witt goes down, and he is slow getting up.
Well, guys, if you look where Montana has struggled in the last several series, Montana State has started to really bottle things up on first down. Think back to earlier in this half. A lot of big first down plays, big first down runs to loosen that defense up. They have not allowed that in the last several series. That D-line starting to get in a little bit of rhythm for the Bobcats.
Second down after the loss on the play of 4. Jordan Canada. Zach Minner out there. Naha Moyakiola, number 2. The lead tackler for the Bobcats. As you get a good look at Jordan Canada's had a very fine season, a 5'9 sophomore out of Duarte, California, South Hills High School. Came into the game with 550 yards rushing. Again, helped pick up the slack when Dan Moore went down with the ankle injury at Eastern Washington. And Schreibeis got a hand on that pass attempt by Smithwick Hand. Fourth down coming up for the Grizz.
Just running the circle flat route, and Schreibeis doing a good job, as much like we saw Wagner. Schreibeis realized he's not going to get there. What does he do? Gets a big hand up.
Not had a sack in this game. A bit surprising. We've got two of the best in the country when it comes to getting to the opposing quarterback. Montana with 39 sacks on the season. Montana State with 34 sacks. That's number 2 in the conference behind the Grizz. And Montana, 4 sacks per game average. That is number 2 in FCS.
Well, I think Jay, you were talking about the Bobcats front starting to make waves, and talked about that weight difference. And maybe there's a little bit of conditioning issue with the big guys up front from Montana.
Well, as big as they are, and we talked about that early in the season, to keep that tempo being 6'7", you know, 325, 330 throughout the game can be challenging. But the other thing that I think has been very effective for the Bobcats is, for the most part, they're just rushing with force. They're able to drop 7 guys back into the secondary and allow them to run to the football.
Take a look at that Montana State defense. Some of the numbers, Jamie Marshall, their defensive coordinator. I mean, they came into this game, guys, 2nd in the Big Sky, fewest points allowed, 22.3 per game. Their total defense, number 1 in the conference. Pass defense, number 2. Run defense, number 1. Although that's been exploited today. That number's getting skewed by Peter Wynn. But all in all, they've been outstanding. And same story for the Montana defense as well. And that's why we've got a 10-7 ball game. with 1:50 left to play in the first half. Shaw on for a punt. Gets it up high. Sean Johnson's just going to get out of the way, and it takes a Montana State bounce. The Bobcats get a break. They will mark that out at the 18-yard line as we return to the Ford Sports Desk and Brad M.
Guys, before halftime in Missoula, we talked Big Sky, of course. Let's also talk some Pac-12. Colorado hosting the Huskies. Nice day for Keith Price and the Huskies. Price, 17-yard score to Kaysen Williams. Price, a big day. 5 touchdowns through the air on the day. The Huskies win their 4th straight, 38-3 over Colorado. Colorado yet to win at home this year. Back to the Big Sky. Eastern Washington on the board again. One of 4 teams tied for the top. The lead standings right now. Portland State on top, 13-7. Back to Missoula, guys.
Brad, thanks. Cody Kirk, not much room. George Tripp in on the stop, number 37. Also down at the bottom of that pile, Josh Harris.
Everybody forgets, because Montana has had a tough time with it defensively, but they're second ranked in the conference versus the run. Top 10 in the country versus the run. Very stout up front.
Pass to Tanner Bleskin. Tanner has his first catch of the game. Dealing with a hip pointer suffered last week at home against Portland State. Good to see Tanner make a reception. His 55th on the season. Averaging 77 yards per game receiving. That's 4th best in the Big Sky. 3rd down, it's been a struggle. 2 of 8 for Montana State this afternoon. McGee with time, open target. Ellis with a reception and drilled out of bounds at the 45-yard line by Matt Hermanson, and that may be an additional 15 yards tacked on to the play.
And Sean Murray tries to bait Denarius McGee into this throw, gets him to throw it, and still doesn't make the play. He is expecting the throw. They run what's called the smash route or China route.
Tom Frazier is our referee. John Ellis is down on the Montana State sideline.
Personal foul, targeting defenseless player, number 12, defense. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Let's talk about the route first, the combination. You got a short route and a corner route. Goodwin baits him into the, Murray, excuse me, baits him in the throw, just doesn't go get the ball. And then to talk about this player right here, he's not defenseless. He is bobbling the ball. You're trying to separate the ball, more of a push out of bounds. Very tough call.
Do you think that call was made, though? And Jason, I'm not sure the angle you had in the helmet-to-helmet contact.
I was right on top of it. I guess that's just a football play, guys.
First down after the gain on the play and the penalty. McGee near sideline. Bleskin with a catch at the 30. Near a Montana State first down. Clock rolling with 46 seconds left in the first half.
And they're destroying the zone by Montana.
Rob Ash calling for a timeout for his Bobcats. 2 timeouts remaining for Montana State. Montana also with 2 as we take a look at the career numbers for the winningest quarterback in Montana State history. Denarius McGee, a record of 28-7, has started every game he's been a part of. Look at the career passing yardage, over 8,600, 69 career passing touchdowns. That is the most in school history, and there's more to come next season when Denarius McGee will be a senior.
Well, think about the 35 games. He's thrown touchdowns in 34 of those games. I mean, it's amazing. I mean, he's had a terrific career and has really just evolved and grown up in this offense. So he's learned how to utilize all of his skills, and they allow him the freedom to do a lot of different things out there.
I think one of the most impressive things about Denarius is from the time he was a freshman, just stepped right into the lineup and played his best ball in the biggest games. And certainly this year, a lot has been expected of him. Turned the ball over early in the season a little bit more than they would like, but he's come on and really been the guy they all wanted him to be. And so much on your shoulders when you're that guy in Bozeman, Montana. But I tell you, he welcomes it. He's got a smile on his face everywhere he goes. And nothing would make him happier than he can get the ball in the end zone here at the end of the first half.
22 touchdown passes on the season, 8 interceptions. Denarius McGee driving his team on second and short. A shuttle pass to Cody Kirk, and he's shy of the first down. Harrison Wagonman snuffed that out. And another timeout taken by the Bobcats.
The Grizzlies,
they have one remaining.
The Grizzlies, excuse me, Tom, are giving Cody Kirk a rough welcome back to the Missoula area. He has not been welcomed back here this afternoon.
You know, Cody, you mentioned he kind of got out of here, got away from Frenchtown, 15 miles west of Missoula, but grew up in a Montana State family, so it wasn't a big stretch for him to go. Number 37, Jordan Tripp, to see Jordan right there in the shot. He and Cody played Little Grizz football together. They were teammates, and so what a thrill it must be each time they meet in this brawl of the wild, and they'll do it one more time next year. Cody a junior, Jordan a junior, and very good friends. The families are close. That's part of what makes a rivalry like this special. Those connected families who, again, for one afternoon, got to go about their own business, pull for their sons and their teams, and then afterwards, they'll be out at the tailgate.
It's amazing when you think about all the stories like that, over the years that have not been told in this rivalry. It's an amazing rivalry.
Jordan went to Big Sky High School in Missoula, and Cody went to Frenchtown High School. Third, very short. Hand off to Kirk, and he'll have the first down with 28 seconds remaining in the half. Montana State quickly back to the line of scrimmage.
Try to kill the ball here. They don't want to save that timeout.
And McGee does exactly that. So 25 seconds remaining in the half. Bobcat men's basketball is back at 2012-2013 season. Tickets are now on sale with a variety of prices and locations. Experience college basketball the way it should be played. Experience Bobcat men's basketball. For tickets, call 406-994-CATS or visit msubobcats.com. Second down. McGee, pressure up the middle, in trouble. The first sack of the game will go to Montana as McGee is dropped. Takai in there, also Zach Wagonman, and we'll have to find out who gets credit for that sack or if it will be a shared sack as Montana State takes its final timeout here in the first half.
And this is just a coverage sack. I mean, it just takes too long. The pocket collapses. You're going to see Wagonman run the stunt inside. See the inside charge right there. He's not able to get home at that point, but a good job of hanging on to the ball. That's just too long, and Denarius's eyes got taken off of his receivers downfield.
Team sack leaders in FCS, Harvard leading the way by one over Montana. Montana State six behind. Third down coming up. 17 seconds left in the half. Montana State out of timeouts. McGee, pressure coming, blindside, unloads. Intercepted at the 5-yard line. Matt Hermanson with the pick for the Grizz with 10 seconds remaining in the first half. So a huge play for Hermanson.
Turn him away with no points. Excellent job. Hermanson coming off of the middle of the field, coming off his hash. He's right here, but he's going to read the eyes and come all the way across the field. And now, what's wrong with that throw? It's thrown too far inside the hash mark. If he throws it up that right hash, you've got Coyle trying to run with Lorenzo Davis. He gets it up early on that hash. You might have a shot, but a nice job by Hermanson.
Second interception this season for Matt Hermanson, a sophomore out of Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Smith-Wigham takes the knee. And that will take care of the first half here in Missoula. The 112th brawl of the wild has been a defensive struggle. As the first half comes to an end, our score, Montana State 10, Montana 7. Let's get you to our Ford Sports Desk, where Brad Adam is standing by.
All right, gentlemen, thank you. A good half so far. Just a three-point lead for Montana State inside the Root Sports Studios. Welcome ahead during our halftime show today. Relive the plays of the year right here in the Big Sky on Root Sports. Remember the first play from scrimmage? Well, that one went 75 yards for a touchdown, plus a grand prize winner in our Big Sky tailgate contest. We're at halftime between Montana and Montana State. Keep it here on Root Sports.
Not to win with some room. Peter is still on his feet.
Yeah.
And off to win. First down and goal. Win inside. Win.
And
touchdown.
We resume our scheduled program.
Thank you for listening.
I know absolutely nothing about this sport.
Whoa! Here's the adrenaline rush. Feels good, don't it?
Welcome to the team.
Hey, Sheldon.
Who are you again?
I'm your girlfriend.
Are you serious about this?
What does it look like to you?
It looks like a wrestler skinned my friend Sheldon and is wearing him like a tracksuit.
Meet Figgle, the free app that rewards you simply for watching DirecTV. Just check in to your favorite shows and start earning points towards a mocha latte, a designer tee, or a trip across the Mediterranean Sea. Hey, they're your points. You choose how to spend them. Download the free Figgle app today and enter promo code DirecTV to unleash exclusive offers and 5,000 bonus points. DirecTV and Figgle. You love TV. Isn't it time TV loved you back?
Every week, the Audience Network brings you special previews of some of the best shows available on DirecTV. This week, see a marathon of the entire first season of BBC America's The Hour, the Golden Globe-nominated spy thriller set in the world of 1950s television journalism.
They will kill me if they know I'm talking to you.
Don't miss a BBC America event on the Audience Network.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema. Meet the men of the watch. Stiller.
We're pillars of the community.
I need your pillar in my community.
I don't know what that means.
Vaughn.
Hell no, it's a weeknight.
Are you serious? I hate it here.
That's my little princess. That's my little angel.
Hill.
I'm gonna report each and every one of you.
Except for those two hot girls I was talking to. Did they say anything when I walked away? Did they say, like, he was nice or he was handsome? Because there's a big difference.
The Watch. Movies start at channel 125.
Meet Figgle, the free app that rewards you simply for watching DirecTV. Just check in to your favorite shows and start earning points towards a mocha latte, a designer tee, or a trip across the Mediterranean Sea. Hey, they're your points. You choose how to spend them. Download the free Figgle app today and enter promo code DirecTV to unleash exclusive offers and 4,000 bonus points. DirecTV and Figgle. You love TV. Isn't it time TV loved you back?
Buffet.
Support the Big Sky Conference and grab the hottest officially licensed gear from BigSkyShop.com. Gear up from head to toe with authentic Big Sky Conference apparel for all your favorite Big Sky teams. Look like a true fan by heading to BigSkyShop.com for hundreds of Big Sky items. Get the best customer service, 365-day hassle-free returns, and $4.99 three-day shipping on any size order. All at the official online store of the Big Sky Conference at BigSkyShop.com.
It's Gonzaga versus South Dakota, Sunday at 1 on Root Sports. Today on Root Sports College Football.
Halftime in Missoula, Grizz running back Peter Wynn. Watch this burst. 47 yards. Montana takes the lead 7-3 at that point. Right now, though, Montana State on top at the break, 10-7. Welcome back, Brad Adam with you here. 125 yards. That's how much offense we saw in the first two plays from scrimmage right here on Root Sports. From there, we saw plenty of amazing moments and fantastic finishes. Here's a look back at the Root Sports Big Sky plays of the year.
Let's go, baby!
Yeah.
catch. It's through his hands, picked up. Bowman, the cutback, still on his feet. Bowman, he'll take it to the house. A terrific catch by John Ellis.
Upended,
touchdown. Going deep, wide open, right down the middle, touchdown. Going deep, Harden with a catch midfield. Again, Harden will take it to the house. Blocked, loose football in the end zone. And over the middle, it's picked off. Weaver still on his feet. A man on a mission.
Fumbles it.
Right away, a statement made. Jump ball, terrific catch. Lorenzo Davis still on his feet. Davis at the 40.
To the top I climb. Norris, and he's got it. Norris takes it to the house. Hope you came to win.
Intercepted. In the room with the blocking. With 6 points. And still on his feet.
And now, we resume our scheduled program.
Thank you for listening.
More dancing from that kid. Will we see another amazing moment in our final game today? We've got a half to go. At half, Montana State on top of Montana at Missoula, 10-7.
Political intrigue.
I am not the enemy here. You do not want to make me one.
An ally betrayed.
I will never forgive you for this.
A plot for revenge.
After everything you did to him, and now you plot deadly revenge?
Only one show can bring you this kind of drama. Call me Fitz.
Fitz o'clock. I'm a councilman now.
Why are we in a naked lady bar?
Die! Die! Why won't you die?
An all-new Call Me Fitz, Tuesday, November 27th, on the Audience Network.
Hey, DirecTV customers, are you ready for another season of nonstop NFL action on DirecTV's Red Zone channel? Each Sunday, we'll take you around the league for live look-ins on every game.
Oh, what a catch!
This is unbelievable.
He's got it for a touchdown.
Get all the action inside the 20 with the Red Zone channel. Order NFL Sunday Ticket Max and save $100 off the regular season price. Call 1-800-GET-SPORTS or go to DirecTV.com/NFL.
I know absolutely nothing about this sport.
Whoa! Here's the adrenaline rush. Feels good, don't it?
Welcome to the team.
Hey, Sheldon.
Who are you again?
I'm your girlfriend.
Are you serious about this? What does it look like to you? It looks like a wrestler skinned my friend Sheldon and is wearing him like a tracksuit.
In Missoula, you don't just tailgate before the game and after the game. You tailgate mid-game, and these are fans making their way back to Washington Grizzly Stadium from their halftime tailgating for the second half between number 2 Montana State and the Montana Grizzlies. Seth Bonner and Tom Glasgow with us. Great to have you with us as the Cats have the 3-point lead at halftime, 10-7. Let's talk about Denarius McGee, the quarterback for Montana State. And your thoughts on his performance, Seth, in the first half?
I thought he did a nice job. Struggled late in the half, but did a nice job in recognition, getting the balls to his guys' hands. Really understood what was happening defensively and got the ball out early, allowed his receivers to make plays, but had the one turnover late. You see the good end cut. All these things went away towards the end of that half as he catches Kruiz Siewing on the corner route. But with his understanding of this offense, they struggled coming down. They had a couple opportunities to really take a hold of this game, but they weren't able to put any points up, and they struggled late.
Denarius, 15 of 29, one interception, one touchdown, 166 yards passing. A huge first quarter on the ground for Peter Wynn of Montana. Things slowed down a bit in the second half. For more on that, our on-field analyst, Jason Stiles. Terrific start for the senior, Jason. I know he'd like to get back into that first quarter groove in the third quarter.
Well, yeah, we talked about the trenches being a big key. Montana came out very hyped up, but I think as the game settled in, you started to see that Montana State defense really take hold. 88 yards for Peter Wynn in that first quarter. A lot of open space, made some guys miss. But as the game settled in that second quarter, just 4 yards rushing, and you started to really see that take effect on first down. When they didn't get yards on first down, they put themselves in long yard situations. That puts the ball in Shea Smithwick hands, and he did not capitalize. They're going to have to either reestablish that run game up front or tell Shea Smithwick hand that he is going to be the guy that has to get it done. I don't think they want to put that pressure on the freshman, so they're going to rely on those big fellas up front, Tom said.
Let's take a look, Jason, at the stats from the first half. And you know, what I think is so important in this game is what is taking place on third downs. And Montana State coming in second best in the conference, 53% clip, just 4 of 11 in the first half. Conversely, Shea Smithwick and his offense have converted on 6 of 11 thirds. So I think that's going to be an important stat set as we move on to the second half and keeping tabs on
it. It really will. It's kind of a role reversal there, you saw in the stats, but second half, the Bobcats are going to have to come out and really get Cody Kirk established, utilize that running game, putting the ball up 30 times in the first half, not their type of game. And for Montana, Shea Smithwick-Hann is going to have to make some plays with his arm. He's going to not be able to miss guys that are open. He's got to make plays if they want to win the game.
And Jason, as we look at the last five games in this series, the clubs have averaged a combined 40-plus points. The defensive struggle so far today. Do we expect to see more of that in the third and fourth quarter?
Well, I think you start to see things open up a little bit. You talked about the number of trick plays. I think both teams have gotten their bag. It's all for naught if you're Montana. This is your last game. You want to spoil the Big Sky Championship for the Bobcats. You're going to let it all hang out. And whether it's Shea Smithwick can, whether it's somebody else that's throwing the ball. But I think turnovers will be a big key here in the second half as well. Guys are really going to be trying to get that ball loose.
And that third quarter kickoff is coming up. It's the 112th edition of the Brawl of the Wild. Great to have you with us on this Saturday on Root Sports. The third quarter's coming up.
The Dan, the myth, the legend.
Have fun.
You're watching The Dan Patrick Show on the NBC Sports Network.
Who's with me?
Are you kidding me?
We play hard, we play hurt, we play tough. Ha! Ask me if I'm an elite broadcaster. Come on this side of the glass and say that to me, you little punk.
I can't believe they let us do this show.
Catch The Dan Patrick Show every weekday morning on the NBC Sports Network.
Seriously, I can't.
I thought I could stop drinking whenever I wanted. When I realized I couldn't, I figured I was just weak. That left me angry and feeling pretty hopeless. Rimrock Foundation helped me find hope again and the desire to get back to enjoying my life. They showed me what my problems were, not just drinking, but depression too. And they taught me how to overcome them day by day.
If you or someone you love has a problem with alcohol or depression, don't give up hope. Call Rimrock Foundation today.
For 160 years. BNSF, the engine that connects us.
Take your golf buddies to the Cedars at Dungeness,
Western Washington's driest championship course.
Beautiful views, challenging course, and great food. So share a day with your buddies. Come to the Cedars at Dungeness and the Seven Cedars Casino, where it's all fun and games.
I'm Denarius McGee, and this is my dream.
Somehow, I end up in a place called Bozeman.
And in this strange and wonderful place, I learn things, amazing things.
From amazing people.
Then suddenly, I'm in the middle of a game. And I throw this pass, and my receiver leaps up and makes this crazy catch.
In my dream, I never let you down. Because you have made my dream come true.
The Bobcat Club, supporting the dreams of MSU student athletes.
This dog's bark, nothing compared to its bite. This is Gonzaga basketball. It's Gonzaga versus South Dakota. Sunday at 1 on Root Sports.
Because the show is so popular, companies are constantly sending us free stuff. It's one of the perks of the gig.
I was supposed to get some shirts delivered here. You guys know anything about this? Seton?
No.
McLovin. Paul, are you sure you know nothing about this?
Oh, I'm shirt.
What?
I'm shirt.
Number two, Montana State, looking to end a two-game skid to Montana in the Brawl of the Wild at 10-7. Bobcats lead as we get ready for the third quarter, and as we send it down to the sideline with Jen Mueller, who caught up with Montana State head coach Rob Ash.
Well, Tom, the focus for the Bobcats in the second half, find a way to get the ground game going on offense. Rob Ash was not happy with the rush yards in the first half and noted that if they don't come up with an answer quickly, a one-dimensional team will be awfully easy for Montana to stop. He was also surprised by the penalties across the offensive line. It's something that they'd worked on in practice this week. He said it wasn't so much focus as nerves and jitters. We will see the defense on the field first as Montana gets the ball to start the second half. For more on the Grizzlies' halftime focus, it's Jenny Kavnar.
Thanks, Jen. I talked with head coach Mick Delaney. He said the message was simple. Finish the drill. This is what we've been working on all season long. This is the end of the season for the Grizzlies. He thought they had excellent play in the first half, minus a couple penalties that they really shot themselves in the foot with. That's their focus this second half offensively. He said first down is going to be key for us. We need to get in more of a rhythm so we can utilize our pass and our run game. We'll see how it plays out for the second half. Tom, we'll send it back to you.
Jenny, thanks so much. Last season when these two teams met in Bozeman at Bobcats Stadium, number one in the country, Montana State, losing to Montana 36-10. And you know they'd like to return the favor here today, along with protecting that national ranking of number two and trying to win a piece of the Big Sky Championship. AJ Silva to kick off. We are underway the second half of the Brawl of the Wild. And deciding to bring the football out for Montana is Ellis Henderson. And Henderson getting out just about the 19-yard line as we take a look at the first half possessions for the Montana Grizzlies in an offense led by number 19, Shea Smithwick Hand. The fumble by Dan Moore. Plenty of punts and obviously an issue that Montana is going to have to work with, finalizing drives. They got down on their first possession down to the 6-yard line of Montana State. Not only could not get it into the end zone on a first and goal from the 6, but missed a short field goal. Edwick Hand fakes the pitch, nowhere to go. Schreibeis brings him down at the 20-yard line, along with some help from outside linebacker Jody Owens.
It's tough to see Smithwick Hand running the option here. Schreibeis comes off and kind of slow plays it. But either you got to pitch or you got to turn up and go. You can't allow them to slow the play down and string it out. That's why the big guys are able to come out and make plays.
And off to Jordan Cannon, and not much room there. Nuh-uh, Moe Akiola driving it back down to the 15-yard line. And a good defensive start here in the third quarter for the Bobcats.
And that's what you call finishing the drill. See, Canada breaks off of the defender, but Moe Akiola just runs him down and stays with it. He runs right through the block of the big guard there.
6 of 11 on third down conversions. The Grizzlies offense, Smithwick Hand has a reception out to Gerald Kemp. And a first down for Montana, a gain of 17 yards.
Utilizing the back shoulder to the big guy. And Kemp's, since Kemp has come onto the lineup, and whether it be special teams, he's been a major contributor. Talked about him earlier, but a nice job adjusting to the back shoulder throw. Good delivery there by Smith McCann.
Third catch this season for Kemp. Of course, just his third game this season. Sam Gratton resetting himself. And off to win. And find a hole on the left side of that line. And not much there as he gets out to the 40-yard line. Caleb Schreibeis with a stop for Montana State.
It'll be interesting to see if on first down Montana comes out and tries to mix up the ratio of run and pass. A lot of running on first down. They've had some success. We also want to give Smith-Wickhand the best opportunity.
Smith-Wickhand will fade around. It looked like there was a hold on Darius Jones. And you can hear the reaction from the Montana fans, but no call on the play. Kemp, the intended receiver.
There's, without question, pass interference there. You're going to see DJ grab a hold of the jersey right there as Kemp does a swim move to go over. Darius Jones grabs him right here, slows down the progress.
Big break for Montana State and Darius Jones. Third down, wide open. Hardy, first down and more. And Hardy down near the 45-yard line of Montana State. It's a big target, very talented target. Greg Hardy, 6'5", 245 senior out of Fairview, Montana. Fairview High School came into the game with 25 catches. Wynn with room, breaks a tackle inside the 30 and down to the 26-yard line. Peter Wynn, nice pickup.
What's changed is the tempo to that offensive line. As you see, Big Dan Moore gets back in the game. But once again, there's another missed tackle on the edge here. Right there, Jones has a chance to bring him down for a short gain. Can't make the play.
Well, set three straight plays now. Darius Jones on the play, pass interference that didn't get called. He was the man responsible in Hardy's flat when he had the big gain, and then that missed tackle right here.
111 yards rushing for Peter Wynn. Smith-Wickhand. And not quite sure what that was all about. Bryce Carver, I guess, just an outlet with Smith-Wickhand in some trouble on the near sideline.
It's kind of the lesser of two evils. Either take it back or let the other guy get hit. Get back to the line of scrimmage.
Bryce Carver with the catch. No gain on the play. Second down. Opening drive here in the third quarter. Dan Moore driving down to the 20-yard line. Darius Jones and Joel Fuller making the stop on the senior out of Tucson, missing five games this season with a high ankle sprain suffered at Eastern Washington.
Look at him just pound for yards. And
guys, he hobbled off the field after that run too. That might be it.
Well, he was tackled down around the ankles. I'm sure that didn't help the situation out.
Took the helmet off, as you saw, as he hit the sideline. On third down, Smith-Wickhand trying to keep the drive alive, flushed out of the pocket, and throws it away.
So outside the tackle box, and a good job of not losing yards and giving special teams a chance to put points on the board. But once again, we see the Montana State defense bending but not breaking.
Chris Leiter coming on for the field goal try. Missed earlier in the game from 23 yards. Leiter 3 of 5 against Weber State, so maybe not as dialed in as he'd like to be. This one from about 38 yards. Leiter's kick again missing to the right. That's about the same distance he missed on in terms of whip to that right upright on that first field goal attempt. So the Grizzlies leading 6 points off the board on a pair of missed field goals by the redshirt freshman.
Talking about a guy that's 15 and 19 coming into this game, has missed 2 field goals. I mean, it's tough, and he's just hooking a little bit, but there's really no pressure. Just gets on it, hooks it around that right, to the outside of that right upright.
Chris going to drink water and certainly hoping he'll have a chance to redeem himself before this game is over. Denarius McGee, Montana State's offense on the field for the first time here in the third quarter, and nothing doing as Cody Kirk is driven back by Benjamin Tripp. Coyle also there. No gain on the play. Montana State rushing in this game, 14 carries, 24 yards.
And right here, they got Benjamin in a flex right here, which gives him all type of range. They don't know where he's going, but you see him stand the guard up and play off. And what athleticism for a big dude, man. 300 pounds, play that like a linebacker.
McGee looking for Flodketter, overshoots him. Matt Hermanson pulling up.
That's a smart play by Hermanson right there. Understanding the situation, no chance for a catch. If he hits that receiver, that's an automatic first down. They're going to give him that call. Smart play by Hermanson.
Well, you remember late in the first half, it was Hermanson with that hit on the sideline, 15 yards, but he was able to redeem himself with the interception to deny Montana State late in the first half. Third down and 10. As we head toward darkness here in Missoula. McGee has a target and has a first down. It's Trey Robinson. Not called his name much, but he is a real receiving threat for the Bobcats. 29 catches coming to the end of the game. Third best on the team, and a pickup on that play of 10 yards. Montana State with a fresh set of downs out to the 30-yard line.
Just a great route by Robinson on the slant.
McGee to Siewing. Dropped after a gain of 4 at the 35-yard line. Cannon got it, and Anthony Goodwin in on the stop for Montana.
Talked about Coach Ash doesn't want this team to become one-dimensional. It happened to him a year ago, and they end up getting beat up, beat down pretty good on their home field. So they've got to do something about this run game, and I think these short passes are an extension of the running game.
McGee, Flodketter, dropped at the 40 by Goodwin. They will mark it out at the 41. That will be a first down for Montana State. Gain of 6 on the play, and the chains move again. First half possessions for the Bobcats. Capped off by that McGee interception. Picked off by Hermanson. Kirk trying to get his day going, stacked up. First contact by Jordan Tripp, and then it was Wagaman who finished off Cody Kirk. One sack in this game in the first half. Half of it went to Wagaman, the other half to Josh Harris. So with that, Zach Wagaman now takes the lead over Caleb Schreibeis as the top sack man of the Big Sky, 11 and a half to 11. Good look at Cody Kirk.
Look at this odd front they're giving. Got a three-man line, but it's a four-man line with Benjamin standing up.
A ton of time. He keeps the play alive, wide open, far sideline. It's Cody Kirk, puts a head down on Hermanson, and they will mark him down at the 32. Check at the 31-yard line of the Grizzlies. Big pickup on the play that time as McGee avoided the initial rush, bought himself some more time, and it's a 26-yard pickup.
You're going to see Denarius start to scramble right, and Tripp comes up instead of staying in his flat. And that's the danger created by Denarius McGee's ability to run the football.
Dragging a couple of Grizzlies after a gain of a couple.
Guys, they've really picked up their tempo offensively as well, reminiscent of what they did in the first quarter. They've found that tempo is really beating Montana's defense, not allowing them to get a line in the defenses, maybe some of the defensive substitutions that they would like to get into with Ty Gregory.
Second down and 8. McGee connects, first down, a yardage to Siewing. Coverage by Sean Murray.
I mean, Jason, do you believe that with the speed of the secondary of Montana, they have got a lot of speed, do you think they need to be closer to these receivers?
Well, absolutely, and they've not threatened deep with the exception of John Ellis. Siewing, while we know he's got some wheels, look at where they are in the field. From a field position standpoint, they can't run that route, so why Sean Murray and company are playing so conservatively is a question.
Gain of 11 on the play. McGee now 20 of 35, 223 yards. And Hand off to Kirk. No gain on the play. Tackled by Caleb Kidder, number 44. Backup defensive tackle for the Grizz.
They're rotating, Coach Gregorak, rotating fresh bodies in and out, keeping guys fresh. He's up that pressure up.
We talked about Caleb Kidder, Tyrone Holmes. This is a defense not only is returning a lot of people, but the guy likes of Kidder and Holmes are going to continue it to be a dominant defense. They've got a lot of depth on that D-line.
Second down and 10. McGee, open target, but actually good help coverage coming over as Flood Kidder was the intended receiver. Murray was there initially, and then nice help over the top by Matt Hermanson.
It was a high low route again. They run the short out with the corner out again. This time, that's how you get back. If you're Sean Murray, that's how you have to get back to break that play up. You can't bait the quarterback in there and allow him to throw it in there. Now, if you're Denarius McGee, you're in the red zone on second down. Look up to that guy running the corner route and then drop it down to your safety valve, Trey Robinson, for a little gainer.
5 of 12 on third down conversions of the Bobcats. McGee, shovel pass inside and nowhere to go for Lorenzo Davis. A loss of 2 yards. Josh Harris snuffed that out.
This is inside option again. Start everything out to the right side. And you see Davis try to come back in, but look at Josh Harris. The senior stays home, slow plays the quarterback who really didn't attack. If you're Denarius, you've got to attack Josh Harris, make him tackle you, and force him to make a decision. And right there, you let him slow play it.
Well, guys, the other thing a shovel pass does in that situation, it minimizes the damage, right? So you're not going to run it. You want to take a chance and maybe slip it behind that first line of defense. But if it does fall to the ground, it's considered a pass, and they can live to play another down.
And that's Harris getting checked out on the field as we send it back to the Ford Sports Desk and Brad Adam.
Guys, while there's a quick break in the action in Missoula, another update on a big sky game as well going on today. Eastern Washington taking on Portland State, a win giving the Eagles a share of the conference title. The Vikings scored the first 13 points, but Eastern has answered the last touchdown from Demetrius Bronson, giving the Eagles a 14-13 lead. So that missed extra point by Portland State looming large right now, Tom.
Yeah, thanks, Rory Perez on for a attempt of 39 yards connected earlier in the game from 42. The kick is up. The kick is good. Rory Perez putting it through. And with 6:51 left in the third quarter, Montana State leading Montana 13-7.
I know absolutely nothing about this sport.
Here's the adrenaline rush. Feels good, don't it?
Welcome to the team.
Hey, Sheldon.
Who are you again?
I'm your girlfriend.
Are you serious about this? What does it look like to you? It looks like a wrestler skinned my friend Sheldon and is wearing him like a tracksuit.
Meet Figgle, the free app that rewards you simply for watching DirecTV. Just check in to your favorite shows and start earning points towards a mocha latte, a designer tee, or a trip across the Mediterranean Sea. Hey, they're your points. You choose how to spend them. Download the free Figgle app today and enter promo code DirecTV to unleash exclusive offers and 5,000 bonus points. DirecTV and Figgle. You love TV. Isn't it time TV loved you back?
Every week, the Audience Network brings you special previews of some of the best shows available on DirecTV. This week, see a marathon of the entire first season of BBC America's The Hour, the Golden Globe-nominated spy thriller set in the world of 1950s television journalism.
They will kill me if they know I'm talking to you.
Don't miss a BBC America event on the Audience Network.
Number 2 Montana State extending its lead against Montana 13-7 early in the third quarter. Last scoring drive capped off by a 38-yard field goal by Rory Perez. 13 plays, 59 yards, 4 minutes and 22 seconds as we're at the midway point. Just about there anyway here in the third quarter of play at Washington Grizzly Stadium in Missoula. A.J. Silva will Getting ready to kick off for the Bobcats. Gerald Kemp and Ellis Henderson back deep to receive as you look at Kemp. That's a guy that's got some tough duty coming up, and you've got to lead that wedge and try to clear a lane for these return guys. Henderson bobbles. So the touchback will bring the ball out to the 25-yard line. Well, let's answer today's trivia question. What is the average temperature for the Brawl of the Wild? The answer is, the fans thought B, 23 degrees. I can understand that. The correct answer is, however, C, 29 degrees.
So my answer would also have been correct.
Which was what?
Cold.
Yeah,
right?
At a different... Although last week,
no,
cold.
That was real. No, that's real cold. It's cold and real cold. Last week was real cold.
Well, and the weather today, I mean, terrific for the players and terrific for the fans and really nothing. Although as we look out and see the flags blowing, there is some wind to deal with for the quarterbacks. Mitch Saylor with the short catch from Smithwick Hand, who is now 16 of 22. In on that last play of 4 yards, so his passing yardage up to 132. Gain of 4, second down at 6. Dancing around Jordan Canada, and Canada has first down yardage. Send it down to the field, Jenny Kavnar.
Yeah, Tom, a little change on the offensive line for Montana. Logan Hines is at center now. That's because Kelby Oyland has left the game. He will not return with a head injury. Hines has played center before. Shea Smith-Hookhan has taken snaps from him. We'll see how it plays out.
Jenny, thanks. Bryce Carver with the reception. And Logan did an outstanding job 2 weeks ago filling in for Kelby when he was suspended for that game against Weber State.
See, you get a look at this defense right here from the Bobcats, and they look content to give up the short pass and continue to bend but not break. But Smith McCann getting on a roll.
And Canada out to the 49-yard line. Schreibeis in on the stop for Montana State. So the 8-yard gain on the previous play followed up. 5 yards picked up by Canada. Fresh set of downs for Montana State. Good look at Shea Smithwick Hand, who took over in the North Dakota game for Trent McKinney. Kemp with a reception, brought down by Cole Moore. Gain on the play of about 4 yards. Season tickets for the defending men's basketball Big Sky champion Montana Grizzlies are on sale now. Big Sky Conference Defensive Player of the Year, Will Cherry, one of the guys who hopes to lead Montana to back-to-back trips to the NCAA tournament. To purchase tickets or for more information, visit the Adams Center box office in Missoula or call 1-888-MONTANA. Trying to set up the screen, and that thing is going nowhere. Jody Owens putting a lick on Peter Wynn.
This is really one of the first times I've seen Montana unable to run this little slip screen to the right side. And Peter Wynn does a nice job selling it. The O-line does a nice job selling it. But if you watch number 23, reads it the entire time. And the right tackle can't get out there.
Loss on the play. Third down and 9. Blitz coming. Smithwick Hand looking for Henderson. And incomplete coverage by James Andrews.
The ball's got to have more air on it there. Trying to throw that fade route. Got him beat. He's got him beat. You're waiting a little bit too long. If you're a receiver, you want to close that gap and climb on top of that defender, but there's no penalty on that play.
No, and said, I think if you're Ellis Henderson, you've got to find a way to get a little more separation and give more room to the sideline. I mean, as a quarterback, you want to be able to drop that over the shoulder. And felt like Ellis Henderson got even, but he wasn't leaving.
Fifth punt today for Stephen Shaw. Fair catch made by Sean Johnson at the 20-yard line. And with 4:26 left in the third quarter, the Brawl of the Wild being led by Montana State.
CenturyLink high-speed internet is $19.95 a month for 5 years.
Really?
Really. It won't change for 5 years. There's no term commitment either. Can cable offer that?
5 years? I like that.
Call now and get up to 12 meg consistently fast CenturyLink high-speed internet for just $19.95 a month for 5 years when you bundle with unlimited nationwide calling. Guaranteed. No term commitment. So lock in your price with CenturyLink today.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema. Meet the men of the watch. Stiller.
We're pillars of the community.
I need your pillar in my community.
I don't know what that means.
Vaughn.
Hell no, it's a weeknight.
Are you serious? I hate it here.
That's my little princess. That's my little angel.
Hill.
I'm gonna report each and every one of you.
Except for those two hot girls I was talking to. Did they say anything when I walked away? Did they say, like, he was nice or he was handsome? Because there's a big difference.
The Watch. Movies start at Channel 125.
Meet Viggle, the free app that rewards you simply for watching DirecTV. Just check in to your favorite shows and start earning points towards a mocha latte, a designer tee, or a trip across the Mediterranean Sea. Hey, they're your points. You choose how to spend them. Download the free Viggle app today and enter promo code DirecTV to unleash exclusive offers and 4,000 bonus points. DirecTV and Viggle. You love TV. Isn't it time TV loved you back?
Big Sky Football on Root Sports is brought to you by Northern Quest Casino, Spokane's newest destination resort. By Jack in the Box. Come to Jack in the Box and try a sourdough cheesesteak melt today. It's got all the best parts of a cheesesteak, but it's on toasty sourdough. By BNSF, the engine that connects us. And by Amica Insurance. Defensive struggle in the 112th edition of the Brawl of the Wild. Welcome back to Washington Grizzly Stadium in Missoula. Montana State with the ball and the lead. Lorenzo Davis made a little bit of something out of nothing as he picks up near a yard. That could have been for a loss, but it has been, and that's a great example of the struggle, Jason. It has been on the ground for Montana State, 28 yards on the ground. Montana, 169.
Well, yeah, really surprising for Montana State, who had really bolstered their run game with the addition of Coley Kirk back into the lineup. But credit this front seven for Montana. They're playing great in front of their home crowd.
Second down and nine. McGee feeling some heat. Again, the escapability coming into play, and Denarius McGee with a first down, brought down by Josh Harris, also Brock Coyle. Gain of 13 on the play.
A 14-yard gain.
And you see the entire time he's escaping. This route is taking a little bit too long. Finally, Tyrone Holmes almost gets home, but you see McGee still with his eyes down the field as he was breaking out of the pocket. And that's where he is dangerous. When he gets out on the move and allows guys to open up, but a nice pickup, gains the first down.
I believe that's the best running play of the afternoon for Montana State. McGee, blitz coming from behind. Ball batted away, ruled incomplete as Sean Murray was coming on the corner blitz. That was close.
Boy, guys, on the Montana sideline, Ty Gregorak is just going nuts after that play. He knows his defense needs a brace, got to try and create something to get in the end zone. And unfortunate, the call did not go his way.
I wonder, let's take a look as we slow it down even more.
I believe it was Lorenzo Davis. Couldn't get there. Got sucked up inside.
And there's the defensive coordinator for Montana, Ty Gregorak. He may have had an argument on that play. Very close. Bottom line, second down and 10 for the Bobcats. McGee with some pressure coming, connects with Everett Gilbert, but for very little on that play. 2 yards as John Cannon gotta have the stop for the Grizz.
Take a look at that last roll there. We had the big tight end back on the opposite side here, Lee Perkins, and they rolled away from him. That's typically where teams like to throw that throwback screen to the tight end. The entire Montana Grizzly defensive line, backers, everything flowed. We'll see if they come back to that sometime later in the game.
The Bobcats 5 of 13 on third down conversions.
Yeah.
Bobcats will go against Montana State. And again, Denarius McGee.
False start, 55, offense. 5-yard penalty, go third down.
Went directly to the man who committed the penalty, the redshirt freshman, left tackle, John Weidenauer.
Coming into this game, he had played so well. I mean, the coaches sang the praises, had no idea that a kid who had never played tackle before in high school, he was a tight end, could come out and play the way he had. But today, he has really struggled with false start penalties and just the overall atmosphere at Washington Grizzly Stadium.
Third down and 13.
Look at all this space between the slot receiver there.
Getting to McGee, three Grizzlies chasing. McGee with a cutback, still on his feet and forced out at the 38-yard line, short of the first down, but a terrific job getting even that yardage by Denarius McGee, a pickup of 7 yards.
This pocket gets collapsed by that tackle end game. You see Bitterman do a nice job. They could have got a hold there on Weidenauer, but a good job of getting outside by McGee. And I think right now, Jay, they're having problems with the tackle and stunts that Montana's throwing at them.
Well, and they're so fast. Tyrone Holmes, a freshman in there, they're so fast, and picking it up has been a big communication issue for the Bobcats.
Perez on for his sixth punt. It's Ellis Henderson back to receive, not Peter Wynn this time, and Henderson making the fair catch at the 15-yard line with 2:11 left to play in the third quarter in Missoula. Number 2, Montana State, up 6 on Montana.
Political intrigue.
I am not the enemy here. You do not want to make me one.
An ally betrayed.
I will never forgive you for this.
A plot for revenge.
After everything you did to him, and now you plot deadly revenge?
Only one show can bring you this kind of drama. Call me Fitz.
Fitz o'clock, I'm a councilman now.
Why are we in a naked lady bar?
Die! Die! Why won't you die?
An all-new Call Me Fitz, Tuesday, November 27th, on the Audience Network.
Hey, DirecTV customers, are you ready for another season of nonstop NFL action on DirecTV's Red Zone channel? Each Sunday, we'll take you around the league for live look-ins on every game.
Oh, what a catch!
This is unbelievable.
He's got it for a touchdown.
Get all the action inside the 20 with the Red Zone channel. Order NFL Sunday Ticket Max and save $100 off the regular season price. Call 1-800-GET-SPORTS or go to DirecTV.com/NFL.
I know absolutely nothing about this sport.
Whoa! Here's the adrenaline rush. Feels good, don't it?
Welcome to the team.
Hey, Sheldon.
Who are you again?
I'm your girlfriend.
Are you serious about this?
What does it look like to you?
It looks like a wrestler skinned my friend Sheldon and is wearing him like a tracksuit.
Take a look at our four game summary with 2 minutes, 11 seconds left in the third quarter. Montana State in front of Montana, 13-7. Rushing yardage, a huge edge to the Grizz over the catch. Cody Kirk just 27 yards rushing for Montana State, and over his last three games, 411 yards rushing with 7 touchdowns. The Grizz on first down and 10, and nothing doing on that carry by Peter Wynn. Zach Minter making the stop for the Bobcats. Guy who may find himself playing on Sundays very
absolutely
short.
Will get the shot. He will definitely get an opportunity.
Simply can. It's Saylor. Good recovery defensively by Darius Jones. And maybe a ball that was just thrown a little bit behind, say.
And tardy, and I'm sure Jay will say the same thing right here. Pound your foot in the ground and get it out in front. But a great job of finishing the play by Darius Jones. That ball's got to be in the air when he sticks his foot in the ground, the receiver. You've got to get that ball in the air. That's a late throw.
Yeah, you're licking your chops and you see that coverage. You know what you want. It's a home run play. Get that ball out of your hands.
Actually, it was on target, not behind him, but that was only part of the equation.
equation.
76, offense, still third down.
He goes against the right tackle, Danny Kistler, 6'8", 325-pound junior out of O'Day High School in Seattle.
Look who's in front of him, though. Come on. he knows. I mean, Shabazz does that to a lot of guys.
By the way, added to the Buchanan watch list this week as the top defensive player in FCS football, Caleb Schreibeis. Smithwick hand going deep far sideline. Intended receiver was Ellis Henderson on that third down play. Good coverage by James Andrews and the punt team coming on for Montana.
But the one thing, you've got to give your receiver a chance to make a play. If you throw it on the white stuff, which is out of bounds, you have no shot to make a play on the football. Give them a chance in that situation. Maybe you get a pass interference, but you throw it out of bounds, there is no chance.
Sixth punt of the day coming up for Stephen Shies, average 33 yards per kick. Johnson back near midfield for Montana State. From his 45, breaks one tackle. Now trying to reverse his field. And finally brought down at the 45. So he ran about 45 yards for basically no gain, but terrific effort by Sean Johnson as we send it back to the Ford Sports Desk and Brad Adam.
Tom Vickie, we're going to go back and forth here in the Rose City today. Portland State retaking the lead. A four-yard pass from Kieran McDonough to Justin Monahan. DJ Adams adds another touchdown run, his third of the game. Vikings back on top in this one, looking for the upset at home. They lead Eastern Washington 26-14. Back to you guys in a big game, as you can see, in the Big Sky standings.
All right, Brad, thanks so much. Going into this final week, four teams with one loss. Montana State can share the Big Sky Championship and earn an automatic berth with a win today and some help. McGee. Deep over the middle, might be picked off. Oh, close. Hermanson nearly had his second interception. Trying to get the number on the intended target. Looks like it was Flotketter. McGee, 22 of 40, 223 yards, a touchdown and an interception.
And I'm trying to figure out what he thought he had there that was a good matchup. You had the slot, Kruiz Siewing going over to the post, but that was not a good matchup there. Hermanson did a nice job staying at home in his zone.
Second down. Kirk. Not much there. Takes it from the 45 out near the 49.
Well, guys, you go back to that previous play, and in tight games like this, you only get so many opportunities to turn the tide for sudden change. We've seen Montana miss two field goals, a sure interception there by Hermanson. Against a good team like Montana State, you got to wonder if you're a Grizz fan how many more chances you're going to get.
What a difference a week and an inspired defense makes. Against Portland State last week, Cody Kirk, 11 carries, 100. 22 yards, two touchdowns on the ground and one through the air. And today, just a massive struggle. 31 yards rushing on 14 carries. McGee on third down. Pressure coming his way. Could not connect with Flotketter as John Cannon-Gatta had the coverage. And the punt team on again for Montana State.
Denarius showing his frustration. He wants his tight end to sit, but he wants him to slide back inside. He is so frustrated. You see, he's being really, I mean, just boisterous to his guys, running up on them. And as a leader, you got to kind of just get your guys with it. You've got the lead. No sense to go crazy on your guys. You still need these guys to make plays for you and to want to make plays for you.
Perez punt, seventh in the game, 13th total in the game. Oh, and that one nearly hit Gavin Hagfors, but it did go out, marked out at the 17-yard line. College Hoop fans, Root Sports is your destination for the best college basketball action, featuring more than 60 college basketball games from top conferences around the country, including the Pac-12, Mountain West, West Coast Conference, the WAC, and much more. For your local programming schedule, visit RootSports.com. This college basketball season, tune in to Root Sports. 48 seconds remaining in the third quarter as Chase Smithwick-Hann and the Montana offense returns to the field, able to generate just 7 points today and down by six. Fake to Canis, McGann in trouble. And brought down by Brad Daly. It's back to the line of scrimmage.
And one of the things that Montana said this week is the Bobcats don't do a whole lot on defense, but what they do very well. And you see these guys are staying home, staying in their gaps. All the trickery and misdirection is really not having a whole lot of effect on them. And once again, Montana puts themselves at a deficit on second down.
Saw Alexi Grozelak do a great job there matching up with his man and didn't fall for the run action.
Joy Counts resetting in the backfield. Smith-Wick hand for Hardy. Makes the grab. First down, Grizz. Greg Hardy on the final play of the third quarter, a 21-yard gain. Alexi Grozelak with the tackle for Montana State. So a little momentum for Montana that they can carry into the fourth quarter as they look to overcome the 13-7 lead held by the second-ranked team in the nation, the Bobcats of Montana State.
Meet Figgle, the free app that rewards you simply for watching DirecTV. Just check in to your favorite shows and start earning points towards a mocha latte, a designer tee, or a trip across the Mediterranean Sea. Hey, they're your points. You choose how to spend them. Download the free Figgle app today and enter promo code DirecTV to unleash exclusive offers and 5,000 bonus points. DirecTV and Figgle. You love TV. Isn't it time TV loved you back?
Every week, the Audience Network brings you special previews of some of the best shows available on DirecTV. This week, see a marathon of the entire first season of BBC America's The Hour, the Golden Globe-nominated spy thriller set in the world of 1950s television journalism.
They will kill me if they know I'm talking to you.
Don't miss a BBC America event on the Audience Network.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema. Meet the men of the watch. Stiller.
We're pillars of the community.
I need your pillar in my community.
I don't know what that means.
Vaughn.
Hell no, it's a weeknight.
Are you serious? I hate it here.
That's my little princess. That's my little angel.
Hill.
I'm gonna report each and every one of you.
Except for those two hot girls I was talking to. Did they say anything when I walked away? Did they say, like, he was nice or he was handsome? Because there's a big difference.
The Watch. Movies start at Channel 125.
Well, when you're a young person growing up in Montana, here's part of what you learn in geography. Where is the Great Divide? And there it is, the Grizz to the west, the Bobcats to the east, and that's the trophy the two teams play for, the Great Divide Trophy. And for the past two seasons, it has been in possession of the Montana Grizzlies, and they're hoping to rally from a deficit of 6 points and keep that trophy right here in Missoula. They used to play the game almost in between the two cities in Butte, kind of at a neutral site. And off. And Canada down to the 45-yard line. Jody Owens knocks him out of bounds. In on the play of eight.
It's a terrific job by Mitch Saylor to seal the edge, which allowed his tailback to get to the outside.
Nice gain on the first play of the fourth quarter for the Grizzlies, down 13-7. Near sideline, Smith-Wick hand overshooting Mitch Saylor. Third and two coming up. Here is Jones with the coverage.
See, that's one of those throws where you're being a little bit too careful. trying to throw the hitch route, but you see coverage coming instead of just getting it out of your hand early, putting it on your guy.
Yeah, those kind of plays have to be automatic, Seth. You're right. Second and short, just an extended handoff.
Was the ball caught by Cam Warren? I guess it was.
How did Cam Warren make that catch?
Brad Daly nearly had the pick.
Unbelievable pick. It's a great job of concentrating by Cam Warren. He stares it down, throws it in there.
Wow.
That great coverage all around.
Definition of threading the needle. First down yardage. Smithwick hand. Going toward Gerald Kemp. Deontay Flowers with the coverage. Look at our stats through three quarters. Again, that big gap in terms of rushing yardage. Denarius McGee's thrown for 223 yards. 5 of 15 on third down conversions in the game for Montana State. And again, coming into this contest, they converted 53% of the time on third down. Second best in the Big Sky behind Cal Poly at nearly 55%. Canada with the handoff, spin move. Jody Owen says hello at midfield. Let's head down to the field and say hello to Jen Mueller. Jen?
Yeah, we're trying to stay warm down here, Tom. You can see that the wind has picked up. There is now trash that is blowing on the field, swirling winds down on the field, and I hate to say it, some precipitation. I'm not sure if it's snow or rain, but there's a little falling from the sky.
Well, it would be appropriate if before this game ended. We saw a few flakes here and there. Third down, 12 for Montana. Their third down conversion rate today, 9 of 17. Ellis Henderson needs to break a tackle, but that is a man who rarely allows that to happen, Jody Owens.
Just staying at home, being patient. And those under routes, and correct me if I'm wrong here, Jace, those under routes are created for man-to-man coverage. You've got to have something built in on the back end. Right there, you see the under coming across, running right into the wheel backer, Jody Owens, who makes that tackle.
Yeah, you build those to run away from people. And Tom, you said it, not many people are running away from Jody Owens. And when you can play that wheel linebacker into the boundary like Jody Owens does, he's close to the line of scrimmage, and he's going to be involved in a lot of tackles.
Seventh punt today for Stephen Shaw. Got a little too much leg into it. The touchback will bring it out to the 20-yard line. Earlier this week, we had a conversation with Rob Ash, the head coach at Montana State, and we asked him about the importance of this game, and he said, this is what our goal chart looks like. Goal number one, when they start a season, beat the Grizz. Goal number two, win the Big Sky. And goal number three, win a national title. Number one and number two may be taken care of in one fell swoop this afternoon. And certainly a shot at number three is in the future for the winningest coach in Montana State history. Rob Ash, a record of 48-21, broke the tie with Sonny Holland last week, who was a guest during our broadcast. And Sonny made the trip, visited with him yesterday. He's here supporting the Bobcats in Missoula. First and 10 from the 20. McGee play fake out to Robinson. Bobbles the football, cannot hold on. And I think, guys, at the very worst, if he held on, he gets maybe a 5-yard gain.
But he at least gives himself a chance. And this, you know, your quarterback's going to be patient with the ball. He throws the check down here. Trey Robinson takes his eyes off it to try to turn up field a little bit too early instead of securing the catch. And right now, there's a lack of focus going on and a lot of frustration going on if you're wearing number 9 in white right now.
Every play magnified in the fourth quarter of a 6-point game. McGee, time in the pocket. Looking for Flodketter, unable to haul it in. Rashawn Murray on the coverage for Montana. Tanner Bleskin, the top receiver for Montana State, limited today due to a hip pointer.
Looks like he's ailing a little bit of some sort. I don't know if, can you see it down there, Jason? It looks like Denarius is ailing a little bit.
Yeah, he, a couple series ago, he came down hard on his hip, and he's kind of been wobbling around a little bit.
They're down and 10. McGee pressure coming. Wagonman nearly had him. Denarius may be able to run for the first down, calling for a block, and this mark is going to be close. Brock Coyle and Jordan trip there, and man, that was a big blow to McGee as he dove for the first down. Now, here's the previous play. I didn't really see anything occur right there, although he did react. I wonder if on the follow through.
Or maybe got kicked in the hip or something inside, but. And this will make him dangerous. He gets out and watch him tuck it, picks up a block, and takes on four Grizzly defenders to pick up that first down.
Well, if you weren't hurt before that play, you certainly could have been after that one, but he did get the first down. Just enough. Robinson, a rare carry for Trey Robinson, and a powerful one out to the 35-yard line. I think another look at Denarius McGee, 1-on-4 on this first down play.
Not what you want to see as the offensive coordinator, your head coach. And look at the guys that are in there. Tripp, Coyle, Hermanson.
Hermanson, I think, maybe was there. I mean, that is some tough running by a tough guy. Second down and 5. Bleskin falling down as he made the catch. It'll be just over a yard shy of a first down for Montana State.
And that one falls on Denarius a little bit as brought Bleskin to the ground. He could have stayed up and converted that first down instead. Now setting up a third and short, but a third down. It's been very difficult for the Bobcats to convert here on the road.
6 of 16 on third down conversions. Just over 2 yards per carry. They have kept him in check. We may have movement, and we do, against Montana State.
False start, 61, offense, 5 yard penalty, still third down.
And right tackle Stephen Foster.
Right there, just that little flinch. But after the third one, I'm thinking I'm gonna go on a different count. I'm not gonna have those guys sitting up there. It's not gonna take me that long, figure it out. Allow your guys to get up and get off the football. We're putting them in harm's way, losing yards to penalties like that.
Third down and 6 coming up.
Showing double pressure up inside.
Making backfield 5 receivers. McGee to Everett Gilbert extends, but is short of the first down by a yard.
Well, I think anytime you get this, look at the middle of the field is wide open, and instead they go with the out route, which is a lot easier to cover and get an angle on. If you run something in the middle of the field, some kind of quick slant, you've got the entire middle of the field wide open, and you can continue to run with that throw.
8th punt of the day coming up for Rory Perez. Barring a fake, I don't think we'll see that here with Montana State up. Ellis Henderson back deep to receive. And Henderson signaling for the fair catch and let the ball go, and it's going to go inside the 5-yard line. It looked to me as if he signaled for the fair catch at the very moment or just after that ball was kicked and then made no attempt to go get it. Now, again, he's the backup punt returner. Peter Wynn is usually in that position, and that play cost Montana some serious field position.
Ford has the freshest lineup in America, so we're at the mall celebrating. Have you seen the new Focus?
I walked in and it was just like, wow.
Seriously fun to drive, 40 miles a gallon on the highway.
40 miles a gallon?
Sync technology, 10,000 separate commands, so you can boss it around, Sasha, to your heart's content.
Are these made here?
Right here in the store. Yeah, a small group of elves come in.
Lease a 2013 Focus for just $159 a month. That's $159 a month on Focus. Don't miss the Ford year-end celebration on now at your local Ford store.
Meet Viggle, the free app that rewards you simply for watching DirecTV. Just check in to your favorite shows and start earning points towards a mocha latte, a designer tee, or a trip across the Mediterranean Sea. Hey, they're your points. You choose how to spend them. Download the free Viggle app today and enter promo code DirecTV to unleash exclusive offers and 4,000 bonus points. DirecTV and Viggle. You love TV. Isn't it time TV loved you back?
Political intrigue.
I am not the enemy here. You do not want to make me one.
An ally betrayed.
I will never forgive you for this.
A plot for revenge.
After everything you did to him, and now you plot deadly revenge?
Only one show can bring you this kind of drama. Call me Fitz.
Fitz o'clock. I'm a councilman now.
Why are we in a naked lady bar?
Die! Die! Why won't you die?
An all-new Call Me Fitz, Tuesday, November 27th, on the Audience Network.
We are back, under 10 minutes to go. Montana State clinging to a 6-point lead in Montana. A look at the other co-leaders. Top of the Big Sky for today. Eastern gotten back on the board. They cut the Portland State lead now to 26-21, that in the third quarter. Meanwhile, down in Flagstaff, Northern Arizona up early 7-0 on Cal Poly, but Cal Poly just tied it at 7. Winner of this game will earn a share of the conference title. So good games there, and a good game in Missoula, guys.
Brad, thanks a lot. So after that mental mistake by Ellis Henderson, who was unable to hold on to that pass at the 10-yard line. First down and 10, now second down and 10 at the 4-yard line. Let's take a look at the punt. It bounced between the 20. The first bounce was between the 20 and 25-yard line. Henderson had signaled for the fair catch.
Almost immediately, there's the 24-yard line bounces.
So that cost Montana 20 yards. Smith-Wick Hand using the stiff arm and a gain of 2. Brad Daly with the tackle for the Bobcats.
It's a good job of reacting by Daly, understanding that he has time and he feels like he's a better athlete than Smith-Wick Hand.
This is where Smith-Wick Hand has to come of age. You got to put the ball in his hand, try and make a play to advance the ball, get a first down. We've got a high risk reward here for the Grizzlies.
See if Montana State comes with a blitz on third down.
Two deep man under him looks.
And here it comes. Smith-Wick Hand across the middle and unable to hang on is Cam Warren. And the punt team returns for Montana. Darius Jones with the coverage.
You got everything you want, but instead of running with just speed, trying to wait, you got to stair step the guy. Cam Warren does a good job of getting open, doesn't finish the catch. A little bit of a conservative call, and I get that because the catch still would have gave him an opportunity to run away, but a little bit of a conservative call there.
16th punt of the game coming up, the 8th for Stephen Shaw, and he needs a big one right here. Standing in the back of his end zone, Johnson at midfield, and into a swirling wind, the ball will settle at the Montana 49-yard line. So a good job by Stephen Shaw. 8:55 left in the 112th edition of the Brawl of the Wild.
Hey, DirecTV customers, are you ready for another season of nonstop NFL action on DirecTV's Red Zone channel? Each Sunday, we'll take you around the league for live look-ins on every game.
Oh, what a catch!
This is unbelievable.
He's got it for a touchdown.
Get all the action inside the 20 with the Red Zone channel. Order NFL Sunday Ticket Max and save $100 off the regular season price. Call 1-800-GET-SPORTS or go to directtv.com/NFL.
I know absolutely nothing about this sport.
Whoa! Here's the adrenaline rush. Feels good, don't it?
Welcome to the team.
Hey, Sheldon.
Who are you again?
I'm your girlfriend.
Are you serious about this?
What does it look like to you?
It looks like a wrestler skinned my friend Sheldon and is wearing him like a tracksuit.
You have limited opportunities to create a relationship with your customers. A trusted business partnership is hard to develop. You're looking for someone to guide you through the tough times. A partner who understands your future goals and needs. From infrastructure to the employees, your name and reputation are on the line. Business hovers around solid decision making. Step into your company's potential with a local bank dedicated to your success. Security you can trust from people you know. Western Security Bank, member FDIC.
Big Sky Football on Root Sports is presented by Ford. We are local. Great to have you back with us. Washington Grizzly Stadium in Missoula for the second-ranked Montana State Bobcats have the lead against the Montana Grizzlies, 13-7, 8:55 left to play. And a first down and 10 for the Bobcats at the Montana 49-yard line. McGee to Kirk. And again, nothing coming easy today for Cody Kirk. Murray and Tripp in on the tackle.
Really, but you have to continue to try to pound him in there, get him going. That offensive line right now has to decide they want to try and close this game out. Putting a score up here makes it a two-possession game, and then that makes it really, really tough for Montana, who's had problems facing that Bobcat defense all day.
Second down and 8. Flat Ketter. Down. They'll mark him out. See if they put it at the 41 or the 41-yard line. Starting center for Montana State, Sean Sampson, number 56. This guy's a terrific story. He began his career as a walk-on. He's a senior. When he arrived on campus, he was south of 200 pounds. Rob Ash never thought he'd play it down for his football team. And now he's the guy that's doing such a terrific job communicating on that line, and he has earned the nickname Hobbit when he showed up on campus. But he's put a lot of weight on, a young man that's really worked hard and part of the winningest senior class in Montana State history.
Did you say earned that nickname, Tom?
I'm a big fan of the films. Right. So to me, Hobbit is a positive.
Well, I tell you what, he has been the glue for this offensive line, a real question mark coming in. And the guy has, anything that goes on up front, he's given those guys the confidence to get it done. And while they may have struggled a little bit today, those young guys have played fantastic all game long. And I talked about it earlier when Coach Jason McAdoo got after him a little bit after a bad series. Sampson was the first guy to pull everybody back together and translate that message, if you will, to make sure that everybody had the right idea. So he has been a heck of a player. Still just 265 pounds. He's playing against a lot of big fellas, but clearly one of, if not the best center in the Big Sky Conference.
Out of Capitol High School in Helena, Josh Harris down for the second time today, and the way he's going off this time, I doubt we will see him return for the remainder of the fourth quarter. Set down to the field and reconnect with Jen Mueller. Jen.
Lots of former players on the sideline today, including former Montana State offensive lineman Mike Person, who is now with the Seattle Seahawks. It's the Hawks bye week, so he drove on over here. He said, you know, there is no professional team here, so that's why everybody gets so involved. He was part of that team that last had the trophy in Bozeman, guys.
Wildcat snap to Kirk. Had the first down, driven back. The mark should have given that first down by a yard. Jordan Tripp with the stop.
Jordan Tripp with the stop.
And again, nothing coming easy today for number 25, Cody Kirk.
Doesn't it seem like it's one of those games where all of a sudden he's just going to break out for a 40-yard run, 30-yard run, and pretty much put the finishing touches on this thing?
15 now, checking 16 carries for 36 yards. I hear what you're saying, and I know that's what Rob Ash is hoping to see, and also the offensive coordinator, Kevin McGivin. On first down, Kirk again. Head down, and
Cody Kirk with a carry.
Tonga Takai making the stop for Montana as we head back to the Ford Sports Desk and Brad Adams.
Tom, thank you. Eastern Washington continues to go back and forth against Portland State in the Big Sky today. Number 5 Eastern just scored on a 36-yard touchdown pass. They've retaken the lead 27-26. Remember, they trailed 13-0 in the second. Meanwhile, Cal Poly's added a touchdown. They lead Northern Arizona 14-7. So a lot at stake in those games, as well as out there in Missoula, guys.
Brad, thanks for the updates. What a game between the Eagles and the Vikings. Muggy. Completion, and that goes to Flodketter, and a first down for Montana State. Hermanson with the coverage, 9-yard pickup on the play.
It's the easiest throw and catch you get. You got your X receiver on the backside, no one underneath. No linebacker. You see the good comeback route. Good job by Flotketter. Come back downhill. Knew exactly where the sticks was. Used his hands. But you got to try and run somebody underneath that X receiver on that backside when he's all alone over there.
Montana needs desperately to come up with a turnover as Kirk gets inside the 25, down near the 20-yard line. The clock quickly becoming an ally of the Bobcats as they look to make this a two-possession game with 6:18 left to play. It's a good insurance policy in terms of ball security to hand it off to in Cody Kirk, but you see how tough the yards have been on the ground for the Bobcats. Kirk with 38, McGee with 31. Lorenzo Davis, and that's a guy who can be an impact player on the ground. Just 1 yard rushing. Of course, they're leaning more heavily on Kirk.
Quinn Catalano just hobbled off the field a little bit. Right guard. Replaced by number 74, Matt Devereaux.
Second down and 5 at the 22. Kirk. Inside the 20. Big pile there. Time will continue to run down. We're inside of 6 minutes now at 5:45. Looks like Kirk was shaken up, hanging that right arm. And obviously with the playoffs looming, you want to do everything that you can do to avoid injury, but sometimes there's nothing you can do.
Well, those two-plus games that Cody Kirk missed earlier this season, first game he's ever missed due to injury, but you spoke of that depth they have in the backfield. It's pretty strong, as good as you get. Really four guys in that backfield that are deserving of carries as Lorenzo Davis replaces Kirk.
Yeah, Davis came into this game 549 yards rushing, 4.5 yards average per carry. Montana State taking its first time out here in the second half. 5:14 left to play, and the Bobcats hoping to close the Grizz out.
Meet Figgle, the free app that rewards you simply for watching DirecTV. Just check in to your favorite shows and start earning points towards a mocha latte, a designer tee, or a trip across the Mediterranean Sea. Hey, they're your points. You choose how to spend them. Download the free Figgle app today and enter promo code DirecTV to unleash exclusive offers and 5,000 bonus points. DirecTV and Figgle. You love TV. Isn't it time TV loved you back?
Every week, the Audience Network brings you special previews of some of the best shows available on DirecTV. This week, see America.
If ifs and buts were candies and nuts, it'd be Christmas every day. If Chris Leiter had connected on the two field goals he missed, we might be looking at a 13-13 game. Missed one in the first half, and then again, as you see, hooking it to the right, two misses in this game for Leiter.
I don't usually do this, but I'm going to come to the kicker's defense. He's not the only one to miss. You had Chase Mithwick Hand miss two wide open receivers on the same drive.
Oh, absolutely.
So they've all shared in the lack of putting points up.
Third down and short. McGee can run for the first down and does. Stretching out near the 10-yard line. 8-yard pickup for Denarius McGee. Brock Coyle in on the stop for the Grizzlies.
And I really, really have to commend him on his being diligent and knowing what's going on. He's got a receiver coming across the back of the end zone. I don't know if you can see him down there, Jay, on the drag route, that he could have thrown that ball for an easy touchdown. Instead, winds the clock, gets an easy first down.
Well, you talk about it with the quarterbacks you train. I do the same. You always have to be aware of down and distance. What is the situation in the game? McGee showed big time that he had that in his mind.
First and 10 at the 11. McGee, design run play. Oh, and a good tackle that time by Bo Tully. McGee was thinking end zone, but Tully with the denial.
This is just a good job of getting upfield and forcing the issue. McGee tries to give him a little stab inside and bounce away, but Boltelli does a nice job of just getting enough of that ankle to bring him down.
Darius McGee, 8 carries, 42 yards, a 5.2 yard average. Yard line.
thought that was one he could have gave to Cody Kirk on the zone read.
5 yard gain. Brock Coyle with the stop.
Well, you kind of get the feeling with McGee's posture and the way he's carrying himself and the plays he's made down the stretch, he wants that load on his shoulders. He wants to carry this thing, whether he gets it into the end zone or whether they get a second score, he wants the ball in his hands.
And those precious seconds ticking off for Montana, trying to deny Montana State. Third down and four. Kirk back in the game. McGee looking to throw back against the grain. Can't, has some room. McGee inside the 5 yard line. Canning got to him first. And fourth down coming up.
Trying to throw the throwback across the field. You're going to see the tight end leaking out, but a good job staying at home by the backside of the Grizz defense. Not able to get it inside, but that is design roll throwback. We talked about that earlier. Now they got everybody going that one direction, tried to sneak the tight end back across the formation. Good job by the Grizz defense to give themselves a chance in this game.
Well, really, both defenses have shown a great amount of discipline this afternoon. With a few times, each one of the offenses tried to get behind it with some trickery. It's been a great job up front, just mano-a-mano, offense versus defense. And then when they've tried to get trick plays behind them, both defense shown a lot of discipline.
Rob Ash allowing the clock to wind down as you look at Ty Gregorak, the defensive coordinator for Montana. 2:35 left to play as Montana State takes a timeout. Looks like they're going to bring Rory Perez on for a field goal, what would be his third of the game, as we take a look at the playoff picture, the wild picture in the Big Sky Conference. Montana State could share the Big Sky Conference title and earn an automatic berth into the postseason with a win here today and an Eastern Washington loss, which could happen, or a three-way tie between Montana State, Eastern, and Northern Arizona. So a couple of ways. Look, they're going to the postseason regardless, but they would love to have that automatic bid going in. Fourth quarter, Eastern Washington up by just a point on Portland State. Perez on. He's connected from distance today of 42 and 38. This from 22 yards. And the kick is good, and it is a two-possession game now at 16-7 with 2:32 left to play. So a touchdown and two-point conversion won't be enough for Montana. They'll need to score quickly and then get an onside kick.
It's a huge kick.
Nick Delaney's first brawl of the wild as a head coach, formerly an assistant coach at Montana State from 1978 to 81. So he knows both sides of this rivalry as we send it back to the Ford Sports Desk and Brad Adams.
Tom, thanks. Just a quick programming note for those of you scheduled to see the Utah Jazz take on the Washington Wizards on Root Sports. We're going to get you to that game immediately following the conclusion of Big Sky football. Right now, though, it's back to Tom, Seth, and Jason there in Missoula. 2.5 to go, guys.
Brad, thanks so much. And it would be of immense help for this Montana offense if either Ellis Henderson or Gerald Kemp can deliver a significant kickoff return. Kemp's longest this season, 41 yards. Henderson, 25 yards. And if you're wondering the last time a Grizzly returned a kickoff for a touchdown, it was back in 2010. A.J. Silva to kickoff for the Bobcats. In the direction of Kemp at the 10. The flip reverse to Henderson, and he has room and gets a block, and Henderson inside Montana State territory. Very well executed play on the kickoff.
Nice job, and I always got worried trying to flip that ball back there instead of handing it off because so many things could happen. But you're gonna see Kemp attack and flip it out, and great hands. Ball is inside of him, great hands by Henderson. This is a tough catch. He's moving full tilt, ball's behind him, and he's able to get around. Then you see the smart decision on the other side of the field on the special teams by not clipping.
Here return in total. Smith-Wick hand fumbles, picks it back up, in trouble. Down he goes, getting back to the line of scrimmage. Grizzlies have to hurry back to the line.
Young sophomores got to focus right here. Got to concentrate. All the little things have to be done right in this particular time of the game.
Approaching the two-minute mark, Montana with all three of its timeouts. Open, Kemp, nice catch. Trying to get to the sideline, out of bounds, and he does to stop the clock. Heads-up move by the senior out of San Diego, Deontay Flowers, with the coverage.
You can see he was tempted to try to cut back inside and make a play, and it's hard not to. Goes up the ladder to make the catch, but he wants to go inside, but gets out of bounds, picks up the first down. Nice job by Kemp.
Gain of 11. Flowers bringing down Henderson, and that was one that Deontay, one more step, and that may have been a pick six, but it is a completion as we're inside of the 140 mark left in this game.
Drove around the outside instead of inside out.
Smith-Wick hand has grabbed and cannot hold on inside the 10. Darius Jones with the coverage.
That's a good job by Darius Jones not to get a personal or a PI call, excuse me, but just on the seam route, ball doesn't have as much on it as it normally would, as Smith-Wick Hand is getting pummeled as he's letting that ball go.
Third down and four. Ball tipped. Looked like it was Schreibeis coming in to get a hand on it. Words being exchanged by Gerald Kemp and Na'a Moyakiola.
Another inside route, and once again, you're not getting home. Look at Schreibeis, and that could have been a holding call there on Kisser, but the big right hand. I tell you, these ends for both these schools are just tremendous players, heady players, and understand how to play that position.
Any chance of winning for Montana, they must get the conversion here on fourth down and four. Montana State looking to stop them and secure win number 10. And it will not happen for the Montana Grizzlies in the 112th edition of the Brawl of the Wild. The Bobcats defense holds, and Montana State will end a two-game losing streak in this series.
And the receivers get tangled up, but you see all the confusion caused by the front seven, and no one knows where anyone's going. Jody Owens almost gets home and forces the early throw. In that situation, though, Jason, I don't know if you saw outside, they had man-to-man, fourth down. Give your guy a chance on the go route. What do you think?
Well, you talk about the down and distance. You're probably thinking, hey, let's just move the sticks. But if they're going to bring pressure, you got to make them pay. I think, though, very fitting that the preseason Big Sky MVP makes the final play and pressuring Smith-Wick Hand to throw that ball early.
Cody Kirk, as the Bobcats will keep it on the ground. Clock is rolling as you look, actually the clock stopping at 1:12 as you look at the Great Divide Trophy. It has spent 2 years in Missoula. It will be going back to Bozeman tonight. Let's revisit our players to watch coming into this game, brought to you by Quicken Loans. Sam Bratton, offensively for Montana, a couple of catches, 14 yards. Dan Moore had one catch for 12 yards, but clearly not 100% coming off that high ankle sprain. Nice day defensively for Montana State's Brad Daly with the 8 tackles, and Jody Owens, 12 tackles on the day for Jody, one of the best in FCS football at that linebacker position. Quiet day for Lorenzo Davis offensively for Montana State. John Ellis with 4 catches. Zach Wagenman did not get a sack today, and it looks, actually Zach got half a sack. It looks like he is going to take the sack title in the Big Sky Conference at 11 and a half. And Jordan Tripp playing like Jordan Tripp plays with 12 stops.
Needless to say, our players to watch from both defenses came to play today, and can't really say that for the offensive guys.
Hand off to Kirk. Securely holding on to that football as we approach the 1 minute mark. By the way, the attendance today, a record in this rivalry, 26,210. All-time, actually, this is the all-time attendance record at this stadium, so it does apply to the rivalry and also to any game played here, beating the record last season set against Eastern Washington of 26,066. Let's send it back to the Ford Sports Desk and Brad Adams.
Well, thank you, Tom. Not a whole lot of offense there in your game, but a whole lot of offense in another Big Sky game in Portland. Eastern Washington has scored again. They are now leading Portland State 34-26. That's 21 unanswered points. Cal Poly's lead is now just one over Northern Arizona, 14-13. Again, Cal Poly and Northern Arizona Big Sky co-leaders along with Montana State. Looks like it's going to stay that way, Tom.
Brad, thanks for the update. And again, your scenarios, Montana State looking for a share of the title, the automatic berth into the playoffs with a win. They're going to get that. And an Eastern loss, it doesn't look like they'll get that. Or a three-way tie between Montana State, Eastern, and Northern Arizona. So right now, the Cats, big fans of Jerome Sauer's Northern Arizona team, hoping they can pull it out against Cal Poly. Kirk. Wrapping up that football. Looks like he has first down yardage. Let's see where they mark. Actually, they're going to mark him just short by a few inches.
You know, the bad part about the whole thing with the tie is one of these teams is going to get left out of the playoffs, and they're very worthy of getting in, whether it be the loser of the NAU and Cal Poly game, probably won't make the playoffs.
That's
that'll be
thinking.
A shame.
Yeah, it really will be, and especially Northern Arizona had that great winning streak going, but potentially for them to end their season with back-to-back losses. Let's head down to the sideline, check in with Jen Mueller.
It is right behind us, and the man presenting the trophy today is Senator Max Baucus. And Max, we were just sitting here talking. This is a big game, and you flew all the way home for this game. Explain the significance.
Well, this is the greatest sporting event in Montana. Today, the greatest attendance of any sporting event in Montana history. This rivalry started 112 years ago, and the score then is almost identical to what the score is today. Doesn't get any better than this. This is Montana. Cat Grizz, it's Montana.
You did not attend either school, but who were you rooting for today?
Look at it. I'm always for this game. There's no better game than Cat Grizz. We have so much fun. You see couples here. My husband went to Missoula. His wife went to Bozeman. They're going to fight and feud. But at the end of the day, it was a great game.
It was indeed. And we're going to go let him find some friends to help him present the trophy. That sucker is huge, Tom.
Jen, thanks so much. He knows his series history. 1897, Montana beat Montana State 18-6. And right now it's 16-7.
Timeout, Montana State.
Timeout taken by
their
Montana State. You know, that may be
the game clock to 50 seconds. 50 seconds.
That may be the first interview the senator has done in quite a long time where he did not hear the phrase fiscal cliff. You know how happy that makes him?
That's why he was excited. He had clear thoughts. He could go back in history and pull out the score just like that. He knew what was going on.
You know, he'll be talking about this one when he returns to D.C. This is it for 12 seniors. 50 seconds left in their Montana career. Brett Bauer, Bryce Carver, Sam Gratt, Jacob Haas, Greg Hardy, Joshua Harris, Jake Hendrickson, Gerald Kemp, Dan Moore, Peter Wynn, Josh Stubert, Caleb Walden. Remember Caleb back at that game at Northern Colorado on a punt play, picked off a ill-advised throw by the Northern Colorado punter, took it in for a touchdown. And let me say Josh Harris. I gave him the formal pronouncement
Joshua.
Of his name is Joshua.
So remember, that's Joshua.
Joshua Denard.
Right.
But congratulations to those 12 players. The hard work it takes to be a college athlete, maintain your academics at a high-profile program like this, those young men deserve a lot of credit. We wish them the best as they move on beyond the University of Montana. And there's Peter Wynn back to return the final punt of his career. 41 seconds left in the game, and a lot of people wondering where was Peter Wynn, and there may be a very good reason why Peter Wynn was not back on that previous punt that was allowed to bounce by Ellis Henderson. But at this point, that's water under the bridge as the offense for Montana State, excuse me, for Montana comes back out onto the field. Peter Wren, Dan Moore, another senior. Win or lose, it's going to be very emotional for them once this game ends. And Schreibeis gets the sack. So he is now the Big Sky sack leader with 12, passing Zach Wagenman, who has 11 and a half.
If you're Wagenman, you're like, come on, Kistler, Pales, you guys got to take care of your boy, man. You can't let those guys come from clean like that.
Smithwick hand, Darius Jones could have had a pick six as that pass was intended for Bryce Carver.
You have to finish the game. Don't just be out there. Finish the game strong.
I agree with you, said they almost thought they weren't going to get back on the field. You can tell they're kind of packing it up and picking up elsewhere, but we've got to come back and at least make a good showing in front of the home crowd.
No timeouts left for Montana. Pass over the middle, incomplete. Intended for Mitch Saylor. Fourth down coming up.
That's a terrific throw right there. That's a ball that has to be caught, but it's one of those balls that's in that area where you know that safety's back there and you could possibly take a shot, but Smithwick Hand did a great job getting back, pounding his foot in the ground, throwing it on time. Ball should have been caught by Mitch Saylor.
Montana State team will make its way back to Bozeman tonight. Tomorrow morning, the selection show for the FCS playoffs at 11:30. Smithwick Hand deep over the middle and nearly picked off by number five, Joel Fuller. 4 seconds left in the game. And they will gather at a restaurant in Bozeman to find out how things lay out for them in the postseason. Today's peak antifreeze, peak performer is, and certainly some good choices, but we go with the quarterback, the winningest quarterback in Montana State history. Denarius McGee, with the win today, takes his career record to 29-7. You see the numbers, 26-47, 247 yards, one touchdown, and an interception for the junior out of Euless, Texas. And McGee will take a knee, and the Bobcats have reclaimed the Great Divide Trophy. They end a two-game skid against Montana as they take the 112th edition of the Brawl of the Wild. And the truck carrying the Great Divide Trophy with Senator Backus coming out onto the field. So Max Backus, the senator representing the Treasure State, out at midfield with the Great Divide Trophy. Bobcat fans who are here enjoying this moment, a regular season that ends with a 10-1 record overall, 7-1 in conference play. This is a team that won at least 9 straight games, 3 seasons in a row, a program first, now 36 wins for the winningest senior class in school history. Rob Ash, the winningest coach in Montana State history, now with his 49th victory. And the focus tomorrow on the selection show, Jen Mueller is with the winning coach, Rob Ash.
Hey, Coach, we do not want to take you away from the celebration, although you've already pointed out that trophy is heavy. You don't want any part of carrying that one, I don't think.
That's for sure.
You know, when we talked at halftime, things were maybe a little tenuous. What do you say about your team in the second half?
This team is so tough down the stretch. Our defense did a fabulous job the whole second half keeping them. We finally got the field position switched with some good punts, and then that last drive, I think we took it with about 9 minutes left, all the way down to 2 minutes, and we finally ran the football, like I told you at halftime, that we needed to do.
And Denarius was one of those ones picking up some of those key plays just to keep the drive alive and the clock in your favor in his performance today.
Amazing performance. He's the best winner I've ever coached at quarterback. He's fantastic. He ran for those first downs. He knew what he had to do. He always seems to help us find a way.
This was number one on your list of goals, was to win this game. Everything else perhaps can fall into place now.
Well, we got two of our goals with this win. The one is beating the Grizz, of course. The other one is now we're also champions in the Big Sky. So it's a pretty nice day.
I hear the fight song playing. You better go join in.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations, Tom.
Jen, thanks so much. And for Rob Ash, a guy that really made a name for himself at Drake and then was presented with this opportunity to take over the Montana State program, what he has done has simply been outstanding, and the fruits of their labors today paying off with a 10-1 regular season, with the playoffs looming and the Great Divide Trophy getting ready for the bus ride back to Bozeman tonight.
I think they'll be FedExing that. I don't know if they'll be bussing that back on the. That's precious cargo, man. You can't just throw that on a bus.
How do you FedEx that short of a few thousand dollars?
Hey.
That is
somebody would be excited to drive that thing back in a nice padded van.
Jason, you're down on the field, and we appreciate everything throughout the day as our on-field analyst. Just talk about that scene down there for those players and what it means. It must bring back some memories.
Well, there's no question about it. These guys, you can just see the joy, all the time that they invested this season, and to get their number one goal that they set out to do and beat the Grizz, really something else. So you talk about this Montana State team and all they've gone across. They've got a lot of opportunities still in this season, but this is as happy as they've been. They know that they'll have at least a share of the Big Sky Conference title, and their number one goal is accomplished. On the other side, you see a guy like Dan Moore. You see some of these seniors walking off the field, a Greg Hardy for Montana for the very last time, and it brings back memories. We all know what that feels like. You know you're possibly never going to play the game of football again, and you don't end it with a win. So mixed emotions out here on the field, but certainly one for Montana State that they'll remember for a long, long time.
Now you see Zach Minner, number 96, leading the charge with that trophy. As big as he is, even he needs significant help carrying that thing. Let's head back down to the field. Jenny Kavnar is with a guy who really had a fabulous game, and it's not the first time.
You think Jody Owens is excited, to say the least here. Tom, you had to run and go touch that trophy because goal number one, beat Montana. You do it your senior year on their field. Can you put into words what this moment will mean in your career?
It's indescribable. I'm undefeated on this field. It feels great. It's a great atmosphere. They fans come out to play, and we did it. I'm glad to be a Bobcat, baby.
Goal number two, Big Sky champs. You can say that now. That is the goal to get you to the playoffs. How will a win like this against a tough in-state rival help you guys for the playoffs?
Well, I see it as momentum. We have momentum going into the playoffs. Unlike last year when we lost to these guys, we didn't go in with no momentum. We had to create our own momentum. So now this is just keep us rolling.
We're going to let you celebrate tonight, but we know you have selection show tomorrow.
Yes,
what do
sir.
You think that will be like?
I just hope we get a good seed, good bid, and all that home field advantage. We deserve it. Can they hear me, y'all? We should get home field advantage, baby.
Jody, thanks so much. Congratulations. Tom, we'll send it back to you.
Jenny, thanks. I'm not sure if that'll influence the committee. I'm not sure the committee needs any influence. I think Jody's right, and I certainly hope that that is what the Montana State Bobcats get. They have worked very hard this season. The one stubbing of the toe at home against Eastern Washington. And for Montana, it has been a long, long time since they have finished a season sub 500. As they lose today, they end their season 5-6. 3-5 in conference play. First losing season for the Grizz since 1985. And again, the playoff puzzle for Montana State. They share the Big Sky title. The only question is, with whom? Eastern Washington at last check on its way to a victory, it appeared, against Portland State. Northern Arizona and Cal Poly. The winner of that game will also get a piece of the Big Sky title. Cal Poly is leading in that game. I believe it was 14-13, the last score that we had. So what a wild way to end what has been just a terrifically fun Big Sky Conference season for us to follow here on Root Sports.
It's been outstanding. Some terrific players to showcase, and glad to be a part of us doing that. I mean, Root Sports would terrific job broadcasting these games. It's been awesome to be a part, and the talent level in this league, I'm telling you, it's a hidden gem for you people that haven't seen it. There's a lot of great players in this Big Sky Conference.
Said a pleasure. Enjoyed it. We'll see you in 2013. More Big Sky football. Jason Stiles, Jenny Kavnar, Jim Mueller, our entire Root Sports crew. It has been a pleasure. That'll do it from Washington Grizzly Stadium, where Montana State wins the 112th Brawl of the Wild, 16-7 over Montana. The FCS playoffs start next week, and while Montana State is sure to have a spot in the postseason, we'll have to wait to see who will share the Big Sky title as the day unfolds. Right now, for those of you in our Root Sports Utah Jazz viewing area, you will be joining the Jazz and the Wizards in progress. For those of you in the Northwest region, we'll take you to Big 12 football in progress, Iowa State against Kansas. That's it. Big Sky coverage on Root Sports for 2012. We'll be back next season. We look forward to it. And again, for everybody at Root Sports, have a great evening.